Canada Championships from Leduc, Alberta, and this is Championship Day for Canadian College and University Championships on the line. In our feature game, the Men's Youth Sports Championship, the University of Alberta Golden Bears, the home team, taking on the Winnipeg Wesmen. Welcome inside a Robinson Arena at the Leduc Recreation Center. It's been a terrific 4 days so far, and now it's time for the National Championship. My name is Matt Cullen alongside Perry Marshall, the head coach of the Ryerson Rams. Perry, it's been a great few days. First, let's meet these two teams, starting with the home side, the University of Alberta Golden Bears out of Edmonton. The skip, Karsten Sturmay, the third, Tristan Stanky, the second, Jason Ginter, the lead, Chris Kennedy, and the alternate, Glenn Van Anse. The coach is Rob Krepps, and this team has been excellent so far, winning 9-3, particularly yesterday in the semifinal over the University of New Brunswick. They've only lost twice, and one of those games was very close against Winnipeg. And Alberta was able to eke out a 4-3 win. That was earlier in the round robin. Speaking of the Wesmen, the University of Winnipeg out of Winnipeg, Manitoba, the skip, JT Ryan, the third, Kyle Deering, the second, Ty DeLello, the lead is Rob Gordon, and the coach, Jerry Sand. Should be a good one. These two teams know each other very well from the round robin and previously from the Western Canadian Championships. And that's where the University of Winnipeg were able to be crowned Western Canadian champions over the University of Alberta. Chance for the U of A to get some revenge, Perry. You had a chance to look at both of these teams coaching with Ryerson, and what were your main takeaways starting with Alberta?
Well, Alberta, highly skilled team. They are solid throughout the lineup. I think they can adapt their game as well, too, to the style that Winnipeg will likely play in this game. Winnipeg with a lot of skill around the hit game, and I think they're going to put rocks in the right places to be able to generate their offense.
Talking with Karsten Sturmay, the skip of the University of Alberta Golden Bears. He's been to the U Sports Championship twice. Both times it's been silver medal. They say three times a charm. What will it take for Alberta to finally get that championship?
I think being patient. I think they're going to have to create their opportunities because Winnipeg can get out of trouble easily. So if they're just patient and waiting for those opportunities, I think that's going to stand Alberta very well in this game.
Alberta will be throwing the Red Rocks in the game. They have won the hammer in the first end. The University of Winnipeg, the Wesmen throwing the yellow stones. Talking with both of these teams, Perry, both mentioning respect for the other team. Certainly have a lot of that when it comes to making tough shots and expect that to be a major factor here.
Yeah, I think you're going to see that each of these teams expects the other team to make their shots, so they know they're going to have to make their shots well. And I don't expect to see a ton of mistakes being made, so it's going to matter really just trying to be patient, wait for those opportunities, and work hard to create them on the ice.
This is one of four Canadian championships, as I mentioned, across the board. We'll keep an updated look on everything else. The University of Alberta Pandas playing the Thompson Rivers Wolfpack. That's the Women's Youth Sports Championship. Douglas and Fanshawe, the Men's College Championship. And on sheet H, right next door, it's the Fanshawe women's team, the Fanshawe Falcons out of London, Ontario, taking on the Camosun Chargers out of Victoria, BC. Karsten Sturmay is one of the best up-and-coming skips this country has to offer. He skipped his team, the University of Alberta, all the way to the Alberta Men's Championship, one win away from the Brier, losing to Brendan Botcher. Botcher ultimately a silver medal. In favor of Brad Gushue. This is a very tough team. They've been in some high-pressure stakes.
Yeah, this environment, I don't think, is going to phase them at all, given their experience, especially their experience most recently at the Alberta Brier. And that experience, I think, is going to come out. Now, don't disregard, of course, the experience of the team from Winnipeg.
The Wesmen, yes.
Because, you know, with JT Ryan and his experience at the 121 Junior Finals in the last couple of years, the rest of the squad, same solid experience. And especially trying to get through Manitoba and being in the 121 playdowns and also their own play in the men's division as well, too. This environment shouldn't faze them either.
Big smiles from the U of A, the Golden Bears. Certainly have to think that there's a bit of extra added pressure playing here at home in front of a loud crowd in Leduc, just south of Edmonton.
Oh yeah, you know this crowd is here. Very much in favor of the Bears, for sure. You could hear them all game. They've now got their, clearly have got their noisemakers out there. We are going to hear them for sure.
You talked briefly, Perry, about the team from Winnipeg and the experience that they have. Certainly JT Ryan skipping Manitoba at the 2018 Canadian Junior Championship. That in Shawinigan, Quebec, a bronze medal for JT Ryan. But the middle of the pack, Ty DeLello and Kyle Deering, 2016 Junior Champions and World Junior Bronze Medalist, playing with Matt Dunstone, a great skip out of the province of Manitoba.
I said that this is a solid squad as well, too. And I think today, if JT is on, he's going to keep that pressure on Karsten for sure.
The 22-year-old from Winnipeg, Rob Gordon. And we're underway. The Canadian Esports Men's Championship here in Leduc.
Halfway.
You're good. Keep going. Yep. Hard.
Keep going. Keep going.
Good.
For the Alberta Golden Bears, the 20-year-old kinesiology student Chris Kennedy from Edmonton, playing
in good.
His hometown crowd.
I'm good.
Top eight.
Over curling slightly.
Top eight, top four.
Over curling right now.
Sliding nice. Alder.
It's always good to get that first one, right? With a skip ask for it.
You know what? Yeah, I'll give you a test for it.
Just bite top four!
I'm good! Room! T-line! Room!
Pilot!
Pilot! Oh, it's got extra on the stick.
It's got a grind.
Kyle, stay close.
Really close, Kyle. One of the major factors of this tournament has been getting used to this ice, going from club ice to now stadium ice, arena ice. And you as a coach certainly witnessed that firsthand. What's your experience there with getting used to this different but great ice?
Yeah, the ice has been great all week, and the ice makers should be commended for that. Clearly, the ice is one component of the environment in the arena, but also this rock set. I think this rock set's the one that was used at the Briar. So the two of those in combination has taken some teams to be able to get used to that, so they don't get exposed to that in their own home environment.
So
I think that gives a bit of advantage too for Alberta, who was doing this in that same environment their run in the men's side.
Hey, let's make this one.
The second for the Wesmen, Ty DeLello.
We said half, right?
24-year-old history major from Winnipeg.
Half your board.
Half.
Yeah,
half.
Like it'll curl. Yeah, it'll curl, Ty.
This is the other thing on hip weight. They're having to feel really comfortable with just how much curl they're going to get. You can see this one here. That's probably even on the guard. They're going to have to work hard to get past that one.
Hard on this yellow tie. You got to go on this yellow.
You miss that broom and those rocks, they're going to take off. And he didn't hit that broom.
On the guard, and now that changes things.
No!
Jason Gittner from Dawson Creek, BC, 24-year-old, has been to two U Sports National Championship. This one, number three.
Room. Here's that. Back four is best.
Yep.
Hard. Hard, just go. You got a good one. Hard.
Keep going.
Interesting here from DeLello using that old broom.
Yeah, and Kyle used to use a broom similar to that before when I first saw him play in 2015, so he's changed to the slider. But I've seen this a few times in the Manitoba, people emulating Jeff and stuff and people like that.
I think it does.
I think there's a standard issue place in Manitoba for things like that.
I think you have to.
Must be.
Thin?
Yeah, and if you hit it, hit it thin into the side.
Yep.
Peel.
All right, Ty.
How much you want to hit?
Wait.
I like how they docked them up a little bit. You know, they've got little Teflon sliders underneath them. And I've seen a stainless steel slider under some of them, too.
Whatever works.
Yep.
Hard.
Got to go.
Touch it. Moving some rocks around. And it's still the Golden Bears lying three.
Got a little too much of the rock.
Touch it.
And almost a fall there for the lead, Rob Gordon. So Winnipeg able to catch his footing at the very last second.
It's a great opportunity for Alberta right now building up. And you can see there's a lot of finish on these rocks too.
Line's great. Stop. Great sweep.
A fourth right into the house for the Golden Bears. They have the hammer, and now Perry, the pressure certainly mounting here on Winnipeg.
Well, he's going to have to probably double out a couple of these ones to be able to try and get out of this thing.
There's no double or anything?
No.
There's this one.
That's pretty good if you can make that.
I don't mind trying it.
Okay. Peel and thick half.
Yeah,
okay,
let's try that.
I think that's a great idea because at the end of the day, he's got a good run on this one the other side to be able to clear those two out. And if you get it two, get from four down to three.
Yeah.
Al Deering, the third for the University of Winnipeg.
He's inside.
Okay.
And just the nose hit.
Okay. Sorry, guys.
Mentioned Deering, a 2016 junior champion.
Even if you roll out, that's the miss.
Canada and a world junior bronze medalist.
Medium here.
Yeah. You got a good ice?
Yeah. 22-year-old Tristan Stenke from Dawson Creek, BC. Both Ginter and Stenke from Northern BC and hoping to do their hometown proud.
Medium.
Yep.
Wearing the green and gold. Another chance here for Deering of the Wesmen.
Yeah, like it looks like a crotch, eh?
Yeah, hit this one first. Peel.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Going after the double again here, Perry.
Yep. Said he's got to get the numbers down. A three in this end for Alberta would be really
hard,
tough
guys.
Start for the for Alberta.
Hard to it.
Gets the two.
Good shot. Yeah.
Might be biting on that 12-foot ring too.
Yeah, if that rock had stayed more and been out-counting the one on the top left, it would have been better for him. But now he's just going to play to that open side. And eventually he's going to have to hit and roll across and try and at least get rid of some of them.
Back to Stenke.
See if it's there.
Line's good.
Go to Wait, close. Close,
guys. Back four, yes.
Close
the
back
eight. Back four, back eight.
This T-line.
Yeah, stay on it.
See back four.
Hard, hard, hard. Hard. Right here, hard, hard, hard.
Good treat, boy.
Great ball.
Good spot. Like I thought, he's going to go after that one double.
I don't think mine will move.
What turn are you throwing?
The out. Like, I think if anything, it'll come up.
Like there?
Yeah.
Okay. Throw well, JT.
Yeah, let's make it, buddy. Let's make it. Get in the beak.
Our first look at the young skip from the University of Winnipeg, JT Ryan, the 20-year-old.
That ice look good.
Studying business.
Oh, oh, yeah, 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 hard, 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 hard.
Yep.
Gets them both. Clutch shot from Ryan.
Might have been interesting to play that shot earlier with the vice, because then it would have left that yellow rock where it was. And
what are you think? I think we're pretty quick.
Yeah, 14-5 is pretty good.
75.
Yeah, so close.
Yeah.
Great.
It's on the tee, okay?
Karsten Sturmay began his curling career at this very club, Leduc Recreation Center. 21 years old.
Mine's a little tight. It's good.
Right on the tee.
Mine's good.
Right on the tee.
Mine's good.
Tee line.
Right on tee.
Over there.
Just tee. Looks there, guys. Looks there. Right here.
No.
Ah, good stop.
No.
Good stop. All good, boys.
Good shot.
And this one
keep looking up.
Slips into the back 12.
He's not going to take a run of that.
Just got good.
That's firm control.
Try and nose it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Control or normal? Firm control.
Yeah. Let's make it, buddy.
Nose hit, and it leaves Alberta here with a chance for two.
Medium, boys.
You got
final stone in the first.
Green, yep.
Karsten Sturmay.
Clean, hard. Clean, whoa, whoa. Whoa. Clean, clean.
Sorry, buddy.
Pitcher gets the two, and it's the home team on the board first with a deuce in the first. And a good start, but it could have been more.
Could have been more. And, Winnipeg is good to get that double on the one side. And then that nice run back double as well to bring it down. That's the power of Winnipeg's typical game, the hit game, so they can get themselves out of trouble with it. Still, a two's a good, given this last game, I think they played, it was a 4-3 final, memory serves me.
Correct, against Waterloo, the semifinal.
Yeah.
Fortunate for this Wesman team that they're even here after the Warriors missed their last shot.
That was tough for that team. I know them well. I'm sure they all feel pretty bad. Still thinking about it in the morning, what could have been.
Pressure shots.
That they are. That's it. That's what you're here for, is you're here to learn those pressure shots. And then you do some things different the next time. But they had that opportunity.
The Golden Bears finished the round robin with a 5-2 record. That was good for second in the pool. Meanwhile, the Winnipeg Wesmen, despite having a very experienced team, had their struggles and finished at 4-3. Had a tiebreaker over Dalhousie by virtue of a win earlier on in the round robin. So here they are on the national championship. And they've gotten better every game, but it's been a struggle at times.
It has, it has. We played them probably the second last draw of the event, and we thought that some of the elements of their game were starting to get exposed when we were playing a little few more rocks in play, grouping them a little bit differently, and also trying to set off the angles a little bit. And then with this ice and these rocks, if they were just a little bit off, as you saw, you know, coming down in that first end, you get a little bit off of the inside.
There.
You don't get the run, you don't get the angle that you want, then you lose the opportunity to score.
Close to Ty's Rock.
That was
almost
a 7-5 victory for your team, the Rams, and Rams over this Winnipeg team.
Get over, Vince. Yeah. Good shot. Good boy. Good.
So it looks like Winnipeg's going to go right back and try and get that deuce back with that corner.
It's good. It's good.
Room now.
Top 12.
Line's good.
Yeah,
both 12
top
and stop. Both 12 and stop. Both 12 and stop.
Most of these games, Perry, we've seen the teams ease into it. A lot of blank ends, even a lot of blank ends in the second end. These two teams going right after it, though, and Alberta put a lot of rocks in play in the first. Winnipeg doing the same here in the second. Are you surprised at how aggressive these teams are in the national final?
Not at all. I don't think there's nerves for either one of these teams. And the fact that they're going after it early and trying to score, they know their opportunities to score are going to be few, so they're going to try and generate as many as they can.
Puppy, wait till I get T-line.
Whoa, guys.
As long as it's buried, it's good.
Bury it, Ty. Yes.
Right back.
Yes, you're buried. Oh,
that's good then.
So if that would have been a three in the first end for Alberta,
good.
That would have been very different than what we see right now.
Ginter studying a Masters of Coaching degree at the University of Alberta.
Great cause, buddy.
Mentioned earlier, Alberta's passed in the 2015-2016 University Championship Games. Both of those for Alberta were silver medals, and a chance here now for that elusive gold.
Hard time.
Just line's
okay.
It's just rolling it.
Good. Okay.
Hack.
Okay. So half weight.
Okay. So watch how those rocks finish hard and if it overcurls. So they're going to go after that yellow in the back.
As soon as the weight comes off, it almost starts going sideways.
And it's almost better if that rock's a little tighter. Then you would be able to use the curl on the ice.
Not aware,
so hot!
Oh, no.
Come on.
Just hack.
Tristan.
And this rolls out.
Good
Interesting, I thought he'd come behind that guard again and try and use it.
Yes, gotta go.
Yeah, gotta go. Hard.
Hard. Hard.
Hard.
Hard.
Hard. Hard.
Looking at the chance at two there.
Okay, we'll take it.
That rolls to bite on the 12-foot ring.
Delello, a multi-sport athlete.
It's been a bit of a theme. A lot of these curlers are terrific athletes in other sports. Delello,
high-level tennis player
out of the University of Winnipeg.
Now into third rocks with Tristan Stenke.
Whoa!
Spent a couple of years at Grant McEwen University right here in Edmonton.
Yep.
Have a team in the college national championship. Earned a spot on the University of Alberta varsity team. Transferred over.
Just biting top four weight.
Yeah.
I gave Ty here for the corner.
I think that's good. Am I freezing to it?
Yeah,
on the corner.
What's the speed like, guys?
It's nice. She has like that 14 and a half
kind of
speed.
Yeah. Well, I've been telling her about 14.3 and I was coming down, so it's probably not the right number.
Kyle Deering.
Top eight.
Fill it a little light.
A little
third
light.
For
I'm
this
good.
Veteran
line's
team.
Great.
Line's perfect.
Line's
from
no
Winnipeg.
Way. Hard, guys.
Top 12.
Line's perfect. Lee's pretty good.
Got room.
Wait on Lee.
That'll be good.
Gotta get it there. Gotta keep going.
Busting now.
Keep going, guys. Come on, you got it. Come on, Gordo. Everything you got.
Hart sweep here from the front end.
Keep going a little more. Go.
Delello and Gordon.
Huge sweep. That's okay.
That's their specialty.
Yeah.
Gotta get it there.
Another look here at the Hart sweep.
Gotta keep going.
Busting now.
Keep going, guys. Come on, you got it. Come on, Gordo. Everything you got. Keep going. Keep going a little more. Go.
Medium.
Yeah. They had that at 15-3, so they brought that a long way.
Biting on the 8-foot ring.
Yeah, hard.
Oh, bigness.
Just getting past the guard, but a flash and a rare miss from the Golden Bears. Didn't have a lot of room. Now, how does that change things here for
right
Winnipeg?
Either that or we could hit on the center, but up to you.
If we hit the one on the center and they don't back, we're not going
to
have a double.
We were able to get that one.
Okay.
It's going to be too sharp.
And that's a little bit of a surprise.
I like this if you have enough.
I like the hack, yeah.
Hack
I got a quarter. Do you want half your back line?
Back line.
Okay.
And if you tick the guard and spin in, he's not.
Just enough to get into the 12 foot.
Yeah.
How's this look?
So it's just back line, right?
Yeah.
So like 7 more feet away?
Yeah, 10 feet more.
How's that ice look?
Looks good.
Yeah.
Looks good.
Yeah.
Looks close to me. For a Carson game for half.
Yeah, it'll take its time. Yeah.
Let's go, buddy.
Just back line.
Yeah. Back line!
Oh.
He's good!
Yep!
Whoa! Oh. All there! Heavy!
Tight!
Hard time,
guys! Go, buddy, dig!
Hard time!
Dig deep, tight! Go, buddy, go! Go! Hard! Roll the shooter that way!
Go,
JT! Sit on top of it!
Go! Good shot!
Great shot!
Yeah, nice shot, buddy! Real good!
Would hope they could push that red one back a little further into the 12 and sit two and
we're
three.
One.
Go, buddy, dig.
Hard.
Dig deep tight. Go, buddy, go. Go, hard. Roll the shooter that way.
Go, JT.
Sit on top of it.
Go.
Good shot.
Good. Yeah, nice shot, buddy.
Yeah, for sure.
Definitely descending.
Okay. So where's ideal? Just straight in front of the 7?
Yeah, straight in front of the 7.
If you're going to air, you're probably on that side. You'd rather him not be able to move it with this, although it's
well,
kind
you
of
don't
safe.
Want him. Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
You just got to make the guard.
Right in front of
him. Sure.
Halfway?
Yeah. Touch more mid.
You have to go inside.
A couple of options here for the University of Alberta. Perry, thoughts on this?
Better.
Yeah, he wants to put that like down and guard that, that run.
75-15, Steve.
Yeah. I said if that red on the back of the eight, if it was back 12, it'd be a little different call.
First of two for Karsten Sturmay.
Mine's good.
Veteran skip of the Golden Bears.
Mine's good. Half tight.
I'll work.
Half tight. Tight. Tight.
Sturmay in this rank were one win away from a berth at the Breyer Championship.
Oh, well.
The
men's
champion championship in Regina.
Deep.
Okay. Okay, Krusty. 4-9.
I think so.
You ever just make this double?
It's close.
Or make the double, the slash double.
I meant this.
Oh, okay.
You like that?
Or can you hit this and roll this over here?
I mean, you could
I was
go,
thinking either that
you
or
go
you,
like that.
I was thinking this way is probably better. If you can make it that way.
You want to go like this? Then he just noses it, though.
Then let's take a rip at that.
Then we have a slash double for two.
If we play this, then I'm gonna have to play a run back for maybe only one on my next.
Yeah, that's
it's
the
only
thing.
For one.
I wouldn't mind killing.
Okay, then are we trying to hit it this way or this way?
This way's probably
it's
better. Just,
it's
actually.
Tough to make this one count.
Yeah, I don't think that one's counting.
Like, is that even good though? Then he knows.
Then
he hits and rolls, and then we have a double.
We got a score though. I think.
Then do you like that? He has to make the guard perfect. Or else it's three. Let's play the double now.
Yeah, I like that.
Play the double.
So playing this?
Yeah.
Either that or you make the place where at least we're shot and we have a chance to score.
Yeah. What do you guys like? It's up to you.
Because if you make this. If he caps it good, we have to make the run.
Yeah.
The run could be for two though, I just have to hit it a hair high.
Okay. If it over curls, you make it like that.
Yeah, peel like a third.
Thin yeah, about a third.
Okay.
Hair thinner.
Great discussion there for the University of Winnipeg, Perry.
And again, you heard them clearly say, you know. We know what we could potentially score. Give them an opportunity to get a two in play here. Otherwise, he's just looking at a one, a tough one, too. It would be a run down. So this gives them the opportunity
that
for that,
there?
Too.
Yeah, maybe an inch more.
Yeah.
Remember, there's going to be three yellow in play here if he plays this shot right.
Oh, yes. Yep. Oh, yes, yes, yes.
JT Ryan.
Whoa.
Great shot. Connects, taking out two reds.
Really good.
Play might get a little more of that red and stick around.
Oh, guys, yes,
great shot. Great shot, JT. Really good.
As the skip, JT is the shot maker. Sets up a final stone here for Sturmay. Leaves the Wesman here. Open hit for two.
Does that look good?
Yeah.
All right, JT, control weight.
Last rock here in the second, and it's right on the nose. Two for the Winnipeg Wesmen. We're all knotted up after two. Golden Bears come out with a deuce. Winnipeg responds.
Absolutely, and that's what they needed to do. It'll help them with their confidence as well, too.
Another look at this last stone, never in doubt, Perry.
Never. A little bit worried when they let it go over his hand, but again, he got good strong sweepers there. He didn't over, he didn't really turn it in too much.
Two teams very evenly matched. Great crowd on hand at the Leduc Recreation Center. This is Robinson Arena. Championship day for the Canadian universities and colleges. And for these two teams, University of Alberta and the University of Winnipeg, it's a chance
right, halfway.
To go to the 2019 Winter Universiad in Russia and wear the maple leaf as Team Canada.
He's close, halfway. How's Ryan?
It's running tight, four.
And this slips into the house.
Scoring in third, he'll probably try and just get another two and four.
Normal, yeah.
Very high percentages so far for both these teams.
Hard,
Alberta
really hard.
91%.
Hard tie.
You really gotta go.
Hard tie.
Skip JT Ryan and the Wesman is perfect.
You're still good. Keep going. You're good.
Sturmay not far behind for Alberta at 94%. Still early, but great start for both these teams.
Corner here.
Back quick here.
It just shows their skill.
It's pretty nice here.
Veteran team from the University of Winnipeg. All four curlers here have experience on the World Curling Tour. Rob Gordon the lead, Kyle Deering the third, both played with Pat Simmons, former Breyer champion, two-time champ. One Breyer's with Kevin Cooey and Team Alberta. Skip JT Ryan has skipped his team to a Manitoba Provincial Championship.
Ryan's good.
Close.
Next generation has arrived.
It has. And that's what University of Curling is all about.
Ought to be out of the ring.
People should come out and watch it more often and just be impressed by how good these young people are.
Terrific matchup here.
Really nice.
In the U Sports Men's Championship.
Attaboy. 16-4.
Call here. Oof, doesn't get much closer than that at all.
Line's good. Halfway's best, boys.
Thanks, heavy guys.
We're halfway tight.
Heavy guys.
A little straighter.
Tight. Tight.
Running a little straighter.
Tight.
Attaboy.
Golden Bears have won two men's championships. 2012 with Brendan Botcher, the Golden Bears.
I don't mind the out turn.
2015 with Thomas Scoff and Jason Ginter on that team.
Should run nice.
Actually, a couple of years ago. And for the University of Winnipeg, looking for its first national championship here. This is actually the seventh consecutive year for the University of Alberta being in the championship game.
I think we're all used to seeing green and gold in these final games.
Coach Rob Krepps, proud of his program, but says the record in the final is 2-5.
Well, you have to get here to have that record.
Tough to get here. Great point.
A little bit, Jay. That's fine.
Women's side has been almost as good. Out of 6 years now, the Pandas have been in the University National Championship.
We've been scrambling early. I think it's good to
keep you updated on that score. 1-0 right now for the team out of Kamloops, BC. Thompson Rivers.
Hang on. Are we rolling in? Like, I can't notice it.
No, just straight around.
Sorry, okay. I thought I was playing normal.
No, heel. Yeah, sorry.
Good to reconfirm.
Bit of confusion for sure.
So you can hear Rob say a little better. Yep. This is a little cleaner in than the first two.
Whoa, easy.
Shot.
All started with that first shot that slipped through the lane.
Exactly.
Even judging,
so
I thought.
The roll there, I mean, you roll it.
Say, Albert will be just as happy. Keep this end clean and go a little harder at it before.
Lines tight. You gotta be on the T line or you're gonna run out of range.
We're almost in.
Gotta be on the T line or you're gonna run out of range.
It's getting better. Let's keep going. Okay. Good job, that's good.
Awesome. You can see how aggressive those rocks are.
Yeah, okay. Firm normal.
As soon as the weight comes off them, they do cut real hard. Those boys knew it. Well, otherwise, they wouldn't have pounded it that hard. JT released that one a little out like that, and it gets out there, it's going to stay straighter.
Empty house for
Mine's good.
Sturmay and the Golden Bears.
Okay, it's pretty good. Looks
great.
This one's going to be a little easier for the sweepers, this one.
Right on to you guys.
Make sure you're in.
Mine's great.
Okay, this is clean.
Sturmay will be competing with his sister Selena at the Mixed Doubles Canadian Championship. That starts tonight.
Same way. Yep.
No rest. Eastern. Oh, no rest at all.
Clean. Yep.
And same
just
for Kyle.
Clean.
Clean.
Clean. Just clean. Clean. That's good. Good shot, JT.
Sturmay is Kyle Deering.
I saw him on the practice sheets this morning because I was working with the Mixed Doubles team. And
good throw.
I said, a little extra practice before today, so don't wear yourself out.
Four Canadian championships in the span of 10 days here in Leduc, Alberta, just south of Edmonton.
Whoa.
A few curlers competing in both the U Sports and the mixed doubles. And we do have a blank end in the third, just how they scripted. Golden Bears keep the hammer, likely to go back on the attack. Great chance here to get you caught up on some other scores as we look across. We have four championship sheets going on here in Robinson Arena. Women's U Sports Championship, still 1-0. The Thompson Rivers Wolfpack over the U of A Pandas.
I'm just gonna get a glass of water.
Word on the red, Aaron.
College championships going on as well. Douglas College out of New Westminster, BC, a 2-1 lead over the defending champions, Fanshawe College out of London, Ontario.
Halfway.
Last stone coming up in the third. And on the women's side, Camosun and Fanshawe, the women's team.
Should be halfway. Fanshawe.
We're right now at two. And that one now early in the fourth.
Should be close.
Biggie, if not at two, that's exactly where we are. A couple of deuces to start things off in the first and second.
Little bit, yeah. A little bit, yeah.
In the third.
That's good. I just want us on that side of the sheet.
Yeah. Halfway is a good depth here.
You got it.
Want to lose ahead in the bronze medal game? 2-0.
Mine's good. Close a little.
Mine's good.
What's going on?
Yeah, we're light.
Just I'll across from us here, Ken's Furniture Arena.
Doesn't need finish.
We gotta go. We're high right now.
Doesn't need finish.
Brock is up 4-0 in the in women's game against Mount Allison. Good for the Brock women. They had a tough loss last night. Good game, really good game.
Yeah.
You still like this one?
I do, yeah. Okay, same throw, touch more weight, yep. Pretty close.
Room. Lots of room.
Tons of room. Tons of room.
Mine's good.
Top
tons
eight.
Of room. Room.
Tons
room.
Of room.
It's running.
It's not moving an inch.
You hard get past that door.
Whoa, it's not even close.
Hammer tie, tie.
Curl it tie. Well, it's not even like, wow.
Did you see it? Wow.
Okay, it's a little heavy. A little bit, actually.
Perhaps finding a straight spot in the ice.
I think he pushed it out a little bit. He was up a little bit on the weight, too, so it just ran.
We're 7-5 here.
That's what we found on the ice.
You think
you
like
know
now?
The path and you get on that path, great. You kind of know exactly what it is. But if you get a little out of that path, you're never quite sure what's going to happen. Some of them will come across right and by, and other ones will just run straight just like that.
Are you live?
Close light.
Are you live? You're in a way over curl.
Tight touch, Will.
You're in a way over curl.
Tough. We're in.
Scott is set. You're in a way over curl.
Yeah, we're in for sure.
That's it.
Okay.
It's really good.
Boy.
Yeah.
As Karsten said, that's going to over curl. It's right out the other side.
Hey guys,
board.
Yeah. Okay, team. Right out to the stick on this one. Right? Yeah. Right. Make sure you're out there. Just board. If you can wick the guard, it's fine. Board wick.
Turn.
Yep.
Just
board
close.
Whoa!
That's good. That's fine.
Right way.
Kyle put that broom to that a little bit earlier. He held that out.
Yeah,
so he got a 15-7 on his last one, so really nice here.
Jason Ginter.
Room.
Yeah, I thought
close. Out of Dawson Creek, BC, same with his third, Tristan Stanky.
Hey, that's fine.
Nose press.
Line's good.
Tight on 12.
Line's great. Hard.
Need a hard
yeah,
sweep.
Hard. Keep going.
Ball's just a bit short.
A little off the path. A little over the path. And you heard Karsten say had too much of the guard. Too much of the guard. They had to wait. Uses that speed.
Pretty good, 14 and a half.
It's going to curl harder.
Hard, hard, hard.
Dragon boy.
Hard, hard, hard. Hard, keep it going.
Should be there. Should be there. Really
back to Ty DeLello, 24-year-old Winnipeg native.
Just top 12, top 8.
Line's good, bitter room. Piles in. Piles are off.
Piles are off.
Hard, Tyler.
Come on, boys, hard.
Keep it going.
Hard! Hard, guys, hard!
Go, 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 go.
That's good there. Good shot. Yeah. Good shot, Ty.
Bit of a missed opportunity. We'll look a little deeper.
Yeah,
that
okay.
Opens up her corner. I don't like coming around again.
I guess then they just suck on her.
Yeah. I don't mind nosing, but I
don't. Two-thirds!
Like
nosing
this instead?
Like, sorry,
the left one. No, we'd like to open up our corners.
That's it.
There you go, bud.
Whoa!
Right on.
That one jams back on the red.
Set it out.
We could rip the corner.
Opportunity perhaps here for the Wesmen.
Like a center.
Jason, what do you think?
I don't know. What do you think?
Talk about it.
Do you guys like this?
Warry rep.
That's kind of what I was thinking. That's not awful.
Don't hate the rep. We're in a good spot right now, but
yeah.
Okay. I mean, if they bury, that's a pretty high guard.
Trying to get lucky.
Then let's do a center. Oh, we're gonna throw a center then.
I don't know. Like,
okay, then throw a center.
You want to just rip it?
No, I don't. I'm good
I don't
with
mind
either.
Putting some pressure.
Okay, let's do that then.
Do you want to put? I don't mind putting a little pressure on. I don't know. I guess it's not the best spot.
Like, it's just that, like, we have one nibbling, but I mean,
I know. We could wrap it.
I don't like that.
Would you like this, guys?
It's fine.
Like, yeah. It's aggressive because he wraps the corner, and then what do we do?
Then you gotta hack it. You gotta follow him down. If he puts it, he just comes around top 12. It's either you follow him down or you have to sink around everything.
What do you think? What's that? I don't know. Let's make a call because we're saying one thing or the other here.
I'm good with whatever you like.
You don't like wrapping the yellow?
I hate that one. Okay. I like either guard or peel.
What do you like? Whatever you like. I don't know.
Okay, let's throw it then. Let's make it.
All right, JT Ryan finally making a decision.
It sounded like the three at the other end were making the decision. Tell desktop JT this is what we want.
Is this the best option?
Well, they want to put a little pressure on. A force would be a good thing for them in this fourth end. Force of one.
Pass the lines.
How much?
It's just three.
Line's good.
Pretty tight. Oh, it's coming down now, yeah.
Rob? Gotta go. You gotta swing it. Until it stops. Keep going.
Go!
Tristan Stanky. Also from Dawson Creek, BC.
Get out.
This one bites on the 12-foot ring.
It was a good outcome for Winnipeg.
Ours is in the house, right? That's pretty good.
Try to take both these yellows out.
Get out.
That's actually not that bad, buddy.
Sturmay saying not that bad. See how Wesman approach this.
Six feet more.
Deering, a junior champion in Canada.
All there. All there.
Mine's
perfect.
Yes,
we never
even touched
it. Good. Nice shot. Slid good down the
middle. Just stays in the rings.
Yeah.
Now he's going to use that tighter red as a better corner.
A little less.
And that yellow was up.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Looks pretty good.
Two shots out for JT Ryan. How does he approach this?
Well, he's going to come down and try and sit on top of that, shrink that scoring area, kind of force Alberta to take that one. Helps to address the issue on the other side, which is the Winnipeg Rocks aren't going to do anything unless we're touching the 12 foot.
A little bit, yeah.
Like if we just bleed, I think that's pretty good ice.
Yeah. That's not bad. Weight size, easy.
Where?
Flat only. All then. Heavy.
Oh, he doesn't want to
heavy. How heavy?
That gate.
Lots of room.
Coming down.
Weight's
still good.
Weight's good.
How's line?
No bounce. You can't bounce on this line, guys.
Weight's there.
Okay, you can't bounce.
Okay, we got to wait then.
Might be too heavy.
No. Sit. Good weight, JT.
White's on the 4 foot ring and is locked right on.
Kind of sucks because we're
the other option is
getting forced if we make it.
Yeah,
I think. Right? I don't know, he's gonna make a good drop next.
Okay, so you're looking for both back 12.
Yeah. I'm thinking here for ice. It's gonna be straight with a couple extra rocks down the track and it's not gonna hook at the end.
The end of 15 now, is 3 rocks down it.
Going to try and come down to that yellow and puff it back to the back 12. Make sure that he tries to roll over on top of that red
back
rock
12.
A little bit so he doesn't, makes it harder for
you guys like that
JT
ice
to
back
double that thing out.
I do, yeah.
I think it's going to be straighter, like we're not going to see the big finish at the end of the end.
Yeah, I would have said 75-15 to hear the team. Just adjust that.
Carson? Golden Bear is addressing the ice conditions again, talking about how much finish beyond this rock. For a bit of extra weight.
Like the weight.
Line's good.
You're such big.
Weight's getting a little big.
Close for line.
Whoa, it's gonna work.
Whoa.
Oh, it'll work.
Whoa.
Weight's good. No. Back 12 just through.
Hard.
Hard, buddy.
Okay.
Ginter with the sweep.
Okay, sorry, Chris.
Just that ran a little bit straight on him. The weight was put.
Well, just through.
Hard, buddy.
Okay.
That plays all right.
It just ran a little bit straight on him, and he had the right weight.
Okay, sorry,
so he didn't get the ability for it to come across the face of the rock. Now JT will hit this one out.
Okay.
He'll want to roll over to prevent that double.
He had that hit for two, I think, right?
think that's good. It shouldn't move too much.
Yeah, I'm trying to roll it over.
Basically,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we're just trying to flip it under a rock kind of thing. Yeah. All right, buddy, let's make it.
Final stone for JT Ryan and the University of Winnipeg trying to.
Weight's good. Weight's good. Tight.
Tight. Hard tight.
Force Alberta.
Hard tight. Hard tight.
Hard tight.
Hard tight. Hard tight.
Hard tight.
Hard tight.
The wand rolls across into the 8-foot ring.
Good shot.
Yeah, good plan B. I threw that a little up and out. Didn't come across.
I was a little wide with it, there. My goodness.
Hard tight.
Carried in behind that, the one that was sitting there not
a little more.
Much. Now it's good.
More.
75-ish. Yeah. Or 15.
Might be tough to get shot rock here. This the shot.
He's got 4 4-foot. Challenge is he doesn't have a lot of space to curl into. Just with that top red.
Last stone here
Line's
for the
really
Golden Bears.
Get some red under it. Get some red under it.
Need a hard sweep. And the front end comes through, bringing it into the 4-foot ring, and it is one. The Golden Bears.
So good outcome for Winnipeg.
Get some red under it. Get some red under it.
It was about a half second down from the weight he wanted to throw, so sweepers judged that one well.
Great crowd on hand, as I mentioned, at the Robinson Arena, watching two University of Alberta teams play for the U Sports National Championship. Golden Bears have a 3-2 lead. The Pandas down 2-0. That one heading into the fifth.
I think I've ever scored 2-5 every game.
So a half year, or sorry, 15
years. Just putting up the scores now. We'll keep you updated.
Yeah.
Close games all across the board. Men's college final, Douglas 2, Fanshawe 2. And the women's final, Mosin Chargers out of Victoria, BC, also locked at 2. The Fanshawe women's
good push,
team.
Guys.
Good.
Keep going,
man. Hard now.
Just top 12 tight.
Hard, boys.
It must be interesting to see that a Winnipeg will hard for two in this end. Try and take the lead into the break. Knowing that the Hammers are in the advantage of Alberta in the back half of the game.
Great sweep, boys.
Both these teams have decorated curlers when it comes to junior careers and even starting for the Sturmay rink on the men's team. And exciting to see that they're opting to play university curling as well on Perry.
Well, these athletes have lots of opportunity to curl, and they have to
Line's
make choices.
Good. Line's good.
And the fact that they actually can make balance it all with their schoolwork sometimes
hard
amazes me.
Hard cow.
Hard cow.
That's when the weight is not
hard
what you wanted.
Get it over there. Keep going.
Line's getting good. Hard cow.
Shot.
Okay.
Kind of blocks that side.
Alright. Yeah, tough one.
Excellent percentages from both these teams. The Wesmen at 88%. The Golden Bears at 89%. Both skips curling at a cool 97%.
One more.
There's your power.
Close.
I was watching the matchup at two. There was quite a difference between Kittner and Diallo early on, but now it's going to come back down.
Hop in, boys.
Let's get it.
Hop in and stop. Can't be behind the team.
Finish my thought on the score updates. Barrier threat two for the Pandas. University of Alberta in the fourth. Tied at two now.
He's real nice.
The Thompson Rivers Wolfpack Women's Youth Sports Championship game.
Should be good.
Line's good. Easy.
Line's good.
Only.
Easy.
Line only.
Room.
Whoa, room. Room.
Room. Room.
Now we're heavy.
Room.
Whoa. Just T-line.
Whoa.
T-line.
Kyle in. Whoa. What else? It's got a curl still.
It's getting better.
It's got a curl.
Right here.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Kyle at the end.
Yep.
Am I throwing that okay? It's just that eight's not moving as much.
You like moving it out?
No.
That,
you're looking for
life. Back eight. It's
15 to see here, so.
So if you just give us like back four out of hand.
Yeah,
about 14.
Be a little frustrating when the rocks don't match the way they throw them. Or want to throw them.
Line's good.
I like it.
Close down.
Well tight.
Tight. Whoa.
Top 14.
Close.
Just top 14.
Yes. Chris.
Oh. That's pretty good, I think.
Kind of counted early, but straightened up.
Go normal.
Well, two-thirds.
Shouldn't
normal.
Do a ton.
Yeah. Okay. Just normal, buddy. Two-thirds.
Whoa. Normal.
No.
Just gets a piece.
Okay.
Again, another one where he let it out the side of his hand.
T-light.
Yeah, I got the glider. So I'll take 3 feet off of that guy.
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
Even a little more than that.
Yeah.
3 feet's perfect, Jay. I got the glider.
Close big. Hold them.
No.
Back four.
Never.
Hold them.
Back four.
T-line, coming down. Coming down a lot.
T-line. Wait, it's good.
Oh.
Yeah, we're all there. Small tap.
Oh, no.
Pistol.
Good judge, Grace.
Good job.
Couldn't get much more accurate than that.
Ouch. That's nice.
No separation, right on top, no angle. Red this? One's not going anywhere.
Got me.
At least one shot.
Free tap, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely, guys.
Free tap, back inside, back
eight. He's going to tap it back a bit. Create some angles.
Last rock here for the second.
It's almost like a mixed doubles.
Back line. Back line.
Hair hot.
Back line.
Tuned up for that tonight.
Curl it.
First draw goes at 8 Eastern time. Mixed doubles Canadian Championship gets underway, and you can catch it. CBCSports.ca.
Oh, boy. All right.
Again, he's just struggling with that release a little bit. Just a little light on his releases. And
halfway.
Very sensitive.
On the logo. Halfway, a little higher.
Chance here for the Golden Bears, Perry, to
quick spot.
Step up the pressure.
Absolutely.
15 quarter even.
Puts another good one out there, taking away that path.
Make your run.
There's a steal possibility.
Well, I guess I'll just steal the line again. We'll be down two. Right?
They're probably trying to set off the angles of those two guards as well.
That's not good.
Right on the button.
Tight.
A little bit.
How much are we looking at?
Tight.
Okay, we're coming around.
Halfway, we stop.
Whoa, it's going
No, we're tight, tight if you stop. Tight if you stop.
Chris, this tight on this one.
Looking a little heavy.
Halfway tight.
Okay, hammer it, Chris. Hard, buddy.
Okay, we're almost top 12.
Hard, hard, hard.
Top 12.
Hard, keep going. Hard, hard, hard.
Yeah.
We're on the beat. Let's go, buddy.
Peel?
I like peel. Yeah. It's not going to do anything.
Okay. Yeah, I just don't really want to hit it high.
Yeah, we're on the nose.
I can't see your broom.
Let's go, Kyle.
4 feet too heavy.
It's nose heavy.
Yeah.
And no yellow rocks.
Good.
About to be four red rocks. I'm sure JT's down there thinking, how am I going to get one from this now?
Two skips there, Ryan and Sturmay. Know each other very well.
Hair more, I thought.
Room now.
Room top two. Top eight, top four.
Room now.
Just top eight.
Top eight. Eight.
Room.
Oh.
Top eight, top four.
Good.
Top four.
Whoa.
Don't want to go.
Line only. We're right on tee.
Okay. 14-6.
Just the same.
Right on the tee line, and now it's four reds, and it gets tougher here for Winnipeg.
No, run it.
Or it's a freeze tap.
Freeze tap, they're right splitting the tee. What do you think? If I ever tap off it, it's really bad. Play the run then, let's just make sure we
probably
score.
Probably the run,
yeah.
Eh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
I think you want to kill this one, just hit hair high.
Yeah.
Like thick three quarters is good. Yeah.
Hair high, same,
I think
same
this
throw.
Is the ball, guys.
Yeah, for sure.
Unless you want to play it this way.
No, this
I
is
like
the right
this way.
Way. Yeah, this is the right way.
Okay.
Oh, oh. Jump. Yep. Yes! Hard!
Got it, jeez.
Getting one.
Overcurled.
Oh, good throw, Kyle. How you guys want to
things are here.
Okay, I like that.
It's getting straighter here, okay?
Okay, just split in top 12. Split in center line, top 12.
Top 12, tuck piece around. You just gotta stay here.
Yeah. Well, that nice 15 here, so.
I'm gonna give you both tight out of my hand, I think.
Yeah, I like that.
Go ahead.
A lot of good information from the front end.
Well, the Golden Bears expressing some frustration with that shot.
Hair high.
Go 2 feet too deep.
Go like this.
Yeah.
Now he's got an angle on the one on the button. He can run back that yellow.
He'll
sit
wait.
There for one.
What are we
behind
playing,
JT?
Are you playing to make this or this?
I think it's real close to. I would rather play this and get rid of this because I think it's real close to sticking it.
I think so too. Heel?
Yeah.
Like, pick three quarters. About there?
Yeah.
He sees that double and a little roll of his rock he's about to hit going underneath the yellow guard. That's his ideal shot.
It's a nice spot here. Maybe a touch of curl, hey? Yeah, throw her well.
Oh, yep. Yeah, hard.
Ah, okay. That's
moves right. A couple of reds, but it still leaves the Golden Bears with one biting the button.
Yeah.
Needed to hit that a little bit higher.
Okay, that's fine.
This one you want to weld right on the nose.
Same weight's
weld
really
touch
good.
High side too, but the miss is of course light.
Okay, so if you give a same weight, that's probably minimum, but
yeah,
I like it.
Final stone here for the Golden Bears and a chance to really put the steel on.
Exactly. If he puts that rock right on the top of that other one, which is what he's called, I'm not sure how JT is going to get it out. And this could be a multiple point steal. Because he's got no place to draw to. He won't be able to get to the button. And the run won't get rid of both of them either.
Line's good. Weight's close. Little down.
Line's great, guys.
Top eight, top four.
I like it already. Whoa.
Get a little finish.
Top eight, top four.
Blue it on.
We're already top four.
Right here, boys.
Yeah.
Blue it on.
Easy.
Trying to glue this on, and a perfect shot from Sturmay.
You can't run it. You can't.
That's the one,
buddy. Got that little bit of the white there. Big shot.
Facing 3-2.
Well, actually, probably more than that.
Could be more.
Those two in the back. They're out counting the one yellow.
That good?
Maybe a sliver left.
Nope.
Yeah.
Take a look at the overhead.
Last rock here for the Wesmen.
Okay, it's all you. Line three. Line three. Running.
It's pretty close.
Running a bit.
Easy.
Running a bit.
Well, it's good.
All you.
How's line?
Got a curl, line.
Got a curl bit. Got a curl bit for the pin. Line will get it. Sweet for T.
We're good.
All you. All you. Sweet for T line. Sweet for T line. You got it, bro. Heart.
Needs to get the button.
Good shot, buddy.
Good shot. It's good.
Now, which one will it be?
I just have to say it, eh? Sorry, JT. Get throw. I think it's one red, guys. Whoa.
Pressure one shot under. From JT Ryan, and he comes up very one close. That angle suggests a red, and the curlers agree. It's a steal for the Golden Bears. Now the lead is two.
Big steal on that end. Good news for Winnipeg. They're going into six, though, with the hammer. Down two. It's not horrible for them, though. Certainly an interesting strategy going into that fifth end. Talked about that, you know, should we try for a deuce? It never really set up for them, and they didn't bail early enough. All those reds were left in play, right? So he was kind of forced to be able to try for the one. Nothing set up for him really well. I think they'll look back at that end and go, strategically, maybe not what we should have done.
Especially when both of these teams are making shots like these. Both the skips here are almost perfect.
They have a really good sense for the curl on the ice and obviously the speed of it right now. So that's a product of being here all week for sure. All these gold medal games are pretty close.
Now we will get you caught up on a couple of scores as we
move into the fifth end break. The Golden Bears with a 4-2 lead thanks to a tough steal. The Golden Bears, let's head down ringside now with the skip for the University of Alberta Golden Bears, Karsten Sturmay. Karsten, a very tight first end. You come up with a big steal. What does that set up now in the back half of this game for your team?
Yeah, I definitely think that we've built some momentum in the first half. I really like how the guys are playing, so just keep up that level of execution, and I like your chances.
All right, let's go back into that fifth end. You had to make a perfect freeze to set up that steal. Take me through what you were thinking on that last rock.
Yeah, we just really wanted to put some pressure on them. I threw basically the same trap with my first one, so we had a really good idea of how it was going to run. So that was a huge benefit, and we made a great team shot.
And it forced JT Ryan with a very tough shot. He just missed, and it resulted in a 4-2 lead. Now, I know you probably don't want to hear about percentages, Karsten, but you're at 98% so far. But here's the bad news. JT Ryan is at 97. How do you get the upper hand and try and take this national championship away from him?
Well, I think it's just about sticking with the process, right? Like, that's what you want. You want a great game. You want two teams playing really well. So we're just really excited to be part of such a high level of execution.
You've been to two university national championships before, looking for that gold medal, and you get a chance to do it here at home. What sort of pressures is it like here?
I think it's really not a pressure. It's a privilege to play at home, to play at hometown. We have our fans and friends and family out to support us, so that's really cool to have the crowd behind us.
And you've got your sister Selena playing in a gold medal game as well. Best of luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, Karsten Sturmay, the skip for the University of Alberta Golden Bears. A perfect freeze in the fifth end to set up a steal. 4-2 for the University of Alberta Golden Bears over the Winnipeg Wesmen. The Golden Bears, you have to think that they have one thing on their mind, and that's redemption after the Wesmen beat them in the Western Canadian Championships. Now here in the University National Championship, Golden Bears, slim lead. We're back after this.
That has to be the most Canadian thing I've ever seen.
Well, maybe if he was also eating a poutine.
Whoa. And drinking maple syrup.
And he's also
a curler.
Guys, you know I've never actually been curling before.
And you call yourself a Canadian?
I'm sorry.
There's more than 1,000 curling facilities in Canada. Be a good Canadian and find one near you today.
A short drive south of Edmonton, Leduc, Alberta, the Leduc Recreation Center. Championship day for the Canadian colleges and universities. Four championship draws going on right now. Let's have a look at some of the college scores. Fanshawe and Camosun. This is the women's draw. Locked at 2. That one just heading into the sixth. And then the bronze medal game. Hometown team from Grant McEwen University, the Griffins, leading 4-2. Over their Alberta rival in the Nate Ooks. Let's have a look at the men's curling championships right now. And Douglas and Fanshawe locked in there. A battle of heavyweights in the college men's division there. That one into the sixth. And the bronze medal game, the Augustana Vikings with a comfortable lead 6-2 over the Nate Ooks, the Northern Alberta Institute of Technology. Lots of championship games going on. We'll get you caught up on the women's scores here as well. The University of Alberta Pandas with a 3-2 lead over the Thompson Rivers Wolfpack out of Kamloops, BC. That one just starting the sixth end as well. And boy, how about the bronze medal game? Krista Nix and the Mount Allison Mounties leaving nothing to chance over the Brock Badgers. A whopping score of 11-0. In our feature game this afternoon, the Golden Bears with a steal in the fifth, 4-2. Bronze medal game going on at the Ken's Furniture Arena just across the hallway. And that's the Varsity Reds out of Fredericton, New Brunswick with a 3-2 lead over Waterloo.
Must have posted that score wrong originally in the Brock Mount A game, because when I checked, it looked like it was different.
Certainly a big score. And here we're getting set for the sixth end, the Alberta Golden Bears. Talked about some of the pressure that they have to face playing at home with Karsten Sturmay, the skip. He says, no pressure, it's a privilege.
Yeah, he's been, I saw him when we first got here, and he's been very comfortable in this environment. I have not seen that feel like he feels that pressure. So this is a good thing for him. You know, you grow up here, you have all these friends and family around you. You know, you can easily wilt into that.
I have to think there's a lot of distractions as well. Friends, family, everybody wants to talk to you. You're in a championship game.
First of all, I think that they're kind of used to that, you know, with the curling that's done out here. And I'm sure that Coach Krepps has prepped them all year for that eventuality. Right, so I'd put a lot of faith in Coach Krepps getting them set for exactly what they were going to be experiencing.
Coach Krepps has coached the men's team from the U of A to 7 straight university championship games. Impressive feats, a strong curling program. This team, though, from the University of Winnipeg, looking for their first national university championship. Very strong team, and with JT Ryan skipping at 97%, he is locked in.
Yeah, and just missed that last shot, right? And again, could have hit at a tie game. And you've got two highly skilled skips here, and their shot making ability is
and they're on today.
No question. Yeah.
Hammer back to the Wesmen here in the sixth. What do you expect? Do you stay patient, or do you go after that deuce right away?
No, I think he'll go hard for the deuce now.
The lead for the Wesmen has certainly had a strong game at 90%.
Line's good.
His counterpart,
easy Kyle,
Chris
easy
Kennedy,
Kyle.
It's running. Battle of leads there.
It's good. Tie it.
It's all about setting up the ends. Leads don't do their job.
Is that in? Oh, that's fast. How is that in?
Lights on the 12-foot ring, and the
you can hear his disappointment.
Wesmen, yeah, disappointed there.
And it's easy to forget because they've had this all week. Is they mop the ice
in
the 5th-end break, right? So it doesn't sit at all.
Medium.
The ice makers do tell me that
medium
when they do that, the speed can actually go back up a little bit. So maybe just that mental lapse.
Attaboy.
Allows the Golden Bears to hit.
With the chance of redemption, put it back up, put it in a good spot this time.
Halfway!
That might derail the plans though for the deuce.
No, off of it, it's all there.
Tough to see.
Do those peels on the intern, hit the rock on the inside, as opposed to doing using the out
like
going
that
out
was,
this
that
way.
Was ridiculous
it's
how
a,
quick
it's
that
a respect for the ice.
I never thought it would have been not
we have seen
years
some of the outturn peel weights over curl if they don't get the weight right, if they don't get the line right, you know, leaving a lot of jams. The risk
perfect.
They're taking is they almost miss, but they've already missed one.
Gregor Wasko, the ice maker.
Like, this looks light, but it's, I know it's going to slide.
This one's moving
it's definitely
a
there, yeah. Yeah.
Years made the ice at the Brier.
Slides.
Made the ice at the Mixed Doubles Olympic Trials in Portage la Prairie, Manitoba.
Attaboy.
Top quality.
Nice shot. Shot tie.
Acknowledge that.
Yeah, one more tie. Same weight's good. Yeah, not a bad. Throw well.
Tighter line on this one, more tighter.
Here less.
Just halfway.
It's good, yeah. Halfway.
There, it's tight.
Oh, it's good, fine, it's fine. Good shot. Good shot. Good throw. Good boy.
If you can make noise on this, that'd be nice.
Yeah.
He doesn't like the way those two reds are set. Because there was a point where after they get rid of these guards where JT's probably going to come around and try and sit close to that black red, use that 1 and 12 foot like a guard.
Very fast.
Yeah, it's pretty quick.
Like 14 and a half or faster?
A bit quicker than 14 and a half.
Back four.
How's the line?
Line's great.
Line only right now. We're all there.
How much?
Definitely to back 12.
Oh. Line's getting good.
Line's good.
Stay close.
It's pretty good weight.
Easy.
Easy.
It's got a curl. Close tie. Hard tie. Hard tie.
Yeah.
Yep, 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 yep. Keep going, keep going, keep
great
going.
Shot. Perfect. Great shot. Great shot, buddy.
Good. Excellent judgment of the weight.
T-line!
They talked well about it.
T-line!
Ice is
back
set up
from
the fifth end.
Okay, that was
14
quarter,
judgment.
Basically untouched.
Yeah, so I could give you a 7-5.
7-5 skill.
Still behind the T line though, so he's liable to come and sit on top of that. Keep the pressure on.
Tristan Stanky, the third.
Oh, heavy.
The Golden Bears out of Dawson Creek, BC.
Can't be big.
This looks a little big.
We're bouncing it.
Don't have room for a bump yet.
Back four, back eight. Bouncing it.
Still gotta work.
We're bouncing it.
Still gotta work. That's pretty good.
Oh,
Chris's hat.
Missy JT just running this, trying to get rid of
some
stuff.
Oh, yeah, I like the
nose angles would be perfect for us.
Same weight, bro. Yeah, exact same. Do you want a hair less weight? Or?
Pretty similar, I think. Not too much less, Kyle.
Oh, same thing.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the same, right? Weight only. Line's great.
Hairless weight.
Weight only.
T.
Find
room.
It.
T-line.
Easy. Line's good.
T-line.
Really got a curl. Got a curl. Line's perfect.
Hard time.
You got to be there. In front of it.
Easy. Easy, just at the end. Easy. Whoa. Yes.
Whoa.
Go.
Good shot.
Now's shot.
Comes up with it. Right
on, yeah.
Very tricky shot.
It's getting straighter here. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Easy, just at the end.
Yes, whoa.
Yes, now.
Good shot.
Hard to get much better than that, Perry.
Yeah, and it's, this shot by Karsten is going to be interesting as well, because if he puts it on the wrong angle, then there is a deuce possibility for JT. So there's not a lot of scoring area for two, though, for JT, which was his hope this end.
Karsten Sturmay has been almost perfect in this game. Curling out of his hometown here in Leduc. Privilege for him to be in two national championships. Mixed doubles starting tonight.
Room right now. A little heavy. Quite heavy.
Work.
Can't bump on this line.
T back four.
Line's getting better.
Yeah, we're bumping. Back four, back eight. We're back eight.
Punches are all there.
Advantage Winnipeg. Need that to finish up a bit more.
I was just
thinking like a regular draw.
I like that.
Yeah.
So I was saying earlier about the ice is that it looked like his path was just a little off from what he threw before. A little out. Went a bit straighter.
Sturmay knows just a little bit off.
Okay, yep. See the expression on his face.
Your turn will throw a little more than him?
I think so, yeah.
Like, are you throwing tee or are you going to be a little heavy?
Tee and have him sweep it.
Okay. Like, I personally like a little bit less.
Okay, I like it, yeah. You can have him sweep it.
Okay.
There?
Yeah. Do you like that?
I do.
If you want more, that's fine.
No.
Whatever you like, bud. I give you a hair more.
Same throw you had last time, basically.
Yeah,
right?
Just tee line, have you guys sweep and just try to roll.
Yeah, just chip and roll.
Come across the top of it. Pop it back a little bit.
All right, buddy.
Probably like to pop it back to the back of the floor.
Does that look good?
Maybe even a little less.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically the same weight you just threw.
Just into this ice, JT Ryan.
It's good. T-line.
Room right now.
Out of Winnipeg.
Still room, guys.
Just tee.
Stay close. Lots of room.
Just tee.
Oh, got a curl still.
We're there. Back four. Back four.
Tie.
Back four.
Tie.
It's not killing me.
Hard tie. Go tie.
Just hit it.
Go, buddy.
Keep going.
Hard.
Keep going, Steve. Go.
How much curl is there at the end of this?
Okay. It's not bad.
Still leave the Wesman. Shot rock. First and third now.
No, but like, I think you probably throw a guard and
let him draw the button. I guess
that's probably your best bet, hey?
Unless you do that, but then it actually makes
it easier.
Well, it's
a gimme,
easier.
Right?
Yeah.
That's your best bet. I think you just guard that.
Yeah. Because I think that's easier.
Well, if you go here, it's a gimme, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you just pick. Yeah.
That's good. Okay.
Here, you think?
Throw the guard.
I like that.
No, respect for JT's side, ability to be able to draw like that pin.
Touch last.
I guess that is the same.
Good decision. Good decision by them. It keeps the pressure on JT to make a tough shot to be able to get his deuce.
Does that still look like too much to you guys or no?
I like that. That's good ice. Yeah. Just halfway tight. Good.
Halfway.
Line's good.
Half.
No finish.
Okay. Doesn't need
to stop.
Half tight.
No finish.
Half tight. Got to stop.
No finish.
Just halfway.
No finish.
Stop.
No.
Bit of finish on the end.
Is he left enough of a hole for him?
He's quite a bit.
Yeah.
I think that's easier.
whatever you think.
Yeah, I have to cross the face pretty good on this one.
Yeah, whatever you think easier, just draw here. Whatever you prefer, man.
I like through the hole. I like to draw away.
Okay, I like it too. You're feeling it so far.
Let's go, JT. Button on this side of my outer.
So enough on that guard from Sturmay to force the draw.
I think that's real close. That's probably max. I think that's good.
You can take an inch less than. We haven't overcurled on one thing all day.
Yeah, I think that's good.
This will be interesting though. They haven't thrown a lot of intern draws on this side. I think a lot of the plays been on the left hand side of the sheet as we're looking down at the.
Down here. So it's going to be really close.
We'll be able to.
Yeah.
This might be challenging if it has the right weight.
Yeah. Does it still look big?
If you, yeah, take
a little less.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, we gotta get to bite the button, so. Same weight.
Last rock here in the sixth, and a tough shot for Winnipeg's JT Ryan. Chance for two.
I had a hair, all you.
It's pretty good. Hair down if anything right
tee.
Now.
Yeah, Ben. Yep. Line's good.
Right on the tee.
Sweet for tee. Gotta go line.
Head down.
Gotta go line.
Hard.
Need a big sweep.
Really gotta go line.
Okay.
Won't be enough.
I said they hadn't played that side of the sheet.
Yellow.
Might have caught something there, or was that just misjudged?
No, I think, as I was saying, the challenge was there hadn't been a lot of draws down on that side of the sheet. And you can see it's a little bit of frost on that side, or at least hasn't been taken off by all the sweepers. And I think it caught a bit of that frost and started to go down.
Let's take another look. This one came up well short.
Out of the hair, all you.
Pretty good. Hair down, if anything, right now.
Tee.
Yep.
Right on the tee.
Right on the tee. Right on the line.
Hard.
Really got to line.
Okay.
And again, JT said out of his hand, he thought he added a bit, right? And Rob, about, you know, 10 feet off the thing, he said was down. Right, so I think it was the frost. I don't think there was a pick there.
So it should be, it's pretty quick, yeah. Eh?
Oh, just a
pretty
horrible fast.
If you're halfway, it's fine. Yeah.
So it is just one for the Winnipeg Wesmen, making it 4-3. Hammer back to Alberta.
Easy, just over.
It's probably halfway.
Just over.
Mine's real good.
Halfway. Let's sit.
Halfway. Bring it tight, Ty. Yeah. Okay.
Pretty nice.
Good try.
So I think we'll probably see Winnipeg trying to get a little more risky.
That's really quick.
What's that?
Strategy. That's so quick.
Team here to tee?
Yeah, I'd say give it 15.
If you're just joining us, this is the men's U Sports Championship game, a chance to go to the University World Stage at the Winter Universiad in Russia.
Good.
Close, guys. If you're just joining us,
heavy.
A couple of deuces to start things off. The Golden Bears with the
top four.
Deuce over. In the first could have been more.
Yeah, maybe Wesman back. Going to come out the other side.
The situation.
It's got to stop to be above T. Well,
okay, wait. Yeah, we need above T. That's
full top four.
Winnipeg coming right back.
Fighting the
with two of their own. Made it 2-2 after two. Single in the fourth for the Golden Bears, and then a perfect freeze from Sturmay on his last rock to force a steal. In the fifth, JT Ryan, his draw coming up just a bit long. Chance for two for the Wesmen in the sixth.
Easy, really
Barry,
easy.
Tough shot on ice that had not
easy.
Been tested for a while and came out well short. One for the Wesmen. That's
bouncing.
Where we stand now.
So Kyle in. Scott
again,
curl.
Strategically,
can't bounce on this
two
side.
Feet. They didn't have that corner guard, right? So they tried to use that center
curl.
As a guard, and everything started to jam up on
okay.
It.
Yeah.
Would have taken a great draw.
Yeah.
It just wasn't there.
Yeah.
That was 4-5, like, not swept at all in the back four.
Yeah.
So it's 15.
If you remember, it kind of started the same way where they gave up the two on the other side. And where they had the blank in the third end. That rock came in, the first one. Just speaks to the importance of those Leeds rocks.
Just hack. It's all hack.
Kristen.
Nice. Do have one final to tell you about. And it's the Brock Badgers on the women's side. In the bronze medal game over Mount Allison, 12-0.
Well, that's good for the Brock ladies. I know a lot of those women
tap it back, okay.
They'll be very happy after last night's
out to the broom.
Last night's loss.
Coming back today with a strong performance, and that one done after the sixth. Wrapping it up early.
He's pretty close.
T.
Light only.
Yep.
You gotta go wait. Gotta go wait.
Heart.
Heart, guys. You gotta
heart.
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 Heart. Heart.
Gotta go.
Sit right there. Good.
Good spot.
Good shot.
Good spot. Could still be picked out. He'll take that guard off.
Hard!
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 Gotta go!
Sit right there. Good.
Good spot.
Good shot.
Good.
Close. Close.
Lean.
Seal.
Lean. Lean. Out of work.
Yeah.
This side's probably more predictable.
Sure.
Yeah.
So pick your side here, eh?
Yeah. Speed's nice.
Yeah. Also, you like the side that you're using all this?
Oh, it's good.
Of course it's more predictable.
More.
That's nice. That's good.
Halfway.
It's good. Halfway. Halfway tight.
Pretty good.
Halfway.
Line's
that
good.
Weight's real good.
It can be Kyle. Line's real good, though.
We're good for weight.
Yep, hard a little. Yep, 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 yep.
Nice shot.
Good brush, guys.
Real good. Shot, Ty.
Carson's not going to leave that over. Talking okay. to his teammates, you know, always affirming the good shots that they make.
Hi.
Halfway.
Kyle Deering, the 22-year-old out of Winnipeg.
Weight's good, halfway.
It's got to curl a bit. Switch. Line's okay.
Kyle and Rob were 2016 junior champions. Won a bronze medal on the world stage.
Yeah, a little bit.
And with Matt Dunstone. In the Manitoba rink.
Nice shot.
Looking to go back onto the world stage here if they can mount a comeback here. Down by one.
So it's kind of tough. I don't want to hit our yellow.
Solid control?
You have to hit it pretty thin to get our yellow.
Control?
Sure. Okay.
Like unless you like the tap. Like hair high.
Yeah, okay. And if you don't make the back double, it's fine. The nose is fine.
He's hit it straight
yellow
here,
stone
right?
Yeah.
Well, that's what he's worried about, is if he hits that at the wrong angle, he's going to kill his yellow. He wants to hit that a little bit thicker. Might get the double in the back and still roll. Around for two.
Just control. Oh,
yep.
Hard.
Oh.
Yes.
Hard tight.
Hard tight.
Hard.
Hard tight. Hard tight.
Hard, hard, buddy.
Hard.
Keep Marlo with the sweep.
Gotta go.
Hard. That's fine. That's
okay.
That's fine.
Rolls past.
Okay.
Yeah. He would have liked some sort of roll.
I think we just roll out. I think he just makes.
Even if he rolled over on top of his own. Same thing back, a little inside creates the opportunity for JT.
So just a control?
Control, yeah, you did.
Keep two in the house and force Kristen to...
if you're positive, that's
first
an access.
Force Kristen
like
to a one.
I think that should be good. Like, you can flop a hair to the... That's great.
Yeah, this one jamming back on their own stone. Keep this game close. Have to think for the Wesmen, they can't afford to give up more than one. Go down by three, if that's the case, or more.
Well, I mean, they like a force in the set. Then they get back on that eighth end with hammers. Two hammers to
go. Two hammers to go.
Just control.
Yep.
Back to
just
Ryan, control. The skip for the University of Winnipeg.
Hard to it.
Hard, buddy.
Hard.
Hard to it. Hard to it. Hard, keep buddy, going, guys. Keep going.
You want to make the double hard.
Yeah.
That's the end?
Yeah. Half rocks. Money.
And again, you see Alberta choosing to use the in turn, respecting that the out turn has a tendency to overcome.
Half rock, boys.
Tougher to put the broom down.
First of two rocks for Karsten Sturmay. Still at 96%. JT Ryan has slipped down to 81. He's had some tough shots. Sturmay winning the battle at the skip position. Hanging into his stones here in the seventh. Double chance here for the U of A.
Sit down.
And it's red.
Sit down.
Oh, button hook there, stays in the rings.
A little too much of the rim. Not right now.
Move a little more on this side of pressure.
Yeah.
So I don't mind solid control.
I think that's good. You could, yeah.
Water room to roll.
Solid, yeah, exactly.
Solid control, it just puts a little bit pressure on here.
You should roll it. Yeah.
Yeah, if it curls a little bit, that's fine.
I think that's close.
Yeah.
Let's go, buddy. Roll it in.
Last rock here for Ryan.
Winnipeg solid control. Control. Solid.
Looking to set up a force.
No, stay close. Rob, stay close.
The U of A.
Yep.
Yes. Oh.
Clean. Yep.
Small roll.
Oh, what's wrong with that?
Nice shot.
Shoot. I'm fine with him taking it back.
Where is ideal will err on the half side.
Yeah, exactly.
Such
is there
precision
a chance
is required.
For a blink?
Absolutely. Looks like there could be could get a double here. We'll throw some weight at this thing and try and make them both go away and then spin out to the right hand side.
Might be a costly miscue then for Winnipeg on that last stone.
Well, you either had to
touch more
a little bit or right in front. Or a lot. If there was a lot, you were gonna miss it.
And Sturmay has been terrific so far. Trying to keep the hammer here.
Clean, you're good.
Takes two yellows, rolls out, and it's a blank for the Golden Bears. Getting out of what would have been a forced situation, and now certainly the advantage shifting to the U of A.
That's right, with hammer, three ends to play, two hammers in your favor.
get you caught up on some scores as we look across the Robinson Arena. Starting with the Women's U Sports Championship, much to the delight of this home crowd, it's the U of A with a 4-3 lead, Hammer in the eighth over Thompson Rivers, BC. That's the score of the Men's College Championship game. Douglas College, a 4 in the seventh.
Steal
of 4 at that. Absolutely correct. Out of New Westminster, BC, 7-2 over Fanshawe.
Just over, guys.
Now heading into the eighth.
Line's good.
Kamosin out of Victoria, BC, the Women's College Championship, 2-2, locked in with Fanshawe.
Whoa, just let it sit.
Four blank ends in a row on that one now in the eighth. Couple of rocks to go. 2-2. Looking like the Wesmen had a chance to force Alberta, but instead, double possibility. Sturmay hits again.
That's that 15 spot.
Now a chance for Alberta to really put the pressure on.
It's almost ironic that the women's and the men's scoreboards exactly the same.
4-3 in each.
And with the hammers.
For Alberta in both cases.
Tight top 12, just tight right now.
You gotta be
I know we're top 12, it's good.
This place.
It's good, top 12, top 8.
Turn into a frenzy if both these U of A teams can win.
We're already fully.
Maybe four.
University of Alberta, the host team here.
That's good.
U Sports National Championship.
I thought Winnipeg might do this.
It's a little straighter, right?
They're going to try and play some steals.
That's okay.
So we're going to put up that second guard.
Line's good. Tight. As tight as you can. Easy. Take a look. Guard curl. Guard curl. Oh, it's good. Line's good, Kyle. Yeah. Heart.
Separation, guys. Heart, guys.
Heart straight. Keep going. Heart.
A couple of guards in line now for the Wesmen.
Just the spotty color.
Easy hack.
Easy hack.
Yeah, I'll give you a little less than my last hack.
Yeah, your last hack was heavy hack.
So here's our first attempt at a tick on this ice with these rocks.
Wait.
Oh!
Light hack!
Both three guards on rocks.
Light hack!
Yes. Cannot leave. Delicate shot.
Yes. Oh, yes!
You're getting too much of it.
Light up!
Roll it, Kristen.
Need these rocks to stay.
Great shot.
Connecting there.
Ball stick.
Yep.
Still super quick. Gonna put it back
up. Still quick. Yeah, for a little time.
Next time you get to work on it.
One. Kyle's rock.
We're there.
Mine's good.
This guy's
all yours. Make sure.
We're good.
Out of boys.
Nice shot, Ty.
Half is good.
Half's good. Whoa.
No.
Never.
No.
You're back on. Yep.
All right. Oh, ends up with a plan B there.
Sorry, guys. Okay. I mean, it was good. I just.
You get the right.
Ginter.
Yeah.
Happy that worked out for him. Looking at the first guard, instead takes out the second.
It's normal game to be here. It's
interesting how the scorekeeper scored that one up there. Scoring doesn't always allow for the plan Bs.
Top eight.
Wait's good.
Wait's
pretty good. Do it.
Easy. Mine's perfect.
Tapping.
Top
four.
Whoa. We don't apply to the top.
How's the line?
Mine's
really quick.
Yeah, Wade's there.
We're tapping for sure.
We're bouncing a little.
Just needs to hit it.
It's around
the
nose.
I don't really want to, JT. It's just got to dig.
Shoulder curl. Yep.
Good. Good shot.
A lot of discussion there. Again, JT Ryan and the sweepers.
Well, we want to try and get those freezes right in the right spot. Any angle, any separation with the guys' weights that they throw gives them the opportunity to blast them away.
Dean!
Whoa!
Dean.
Better throw that time.
Better.
How tight?
Like top, almost top 12. It's gotta sit.
Oh,
it's
drying.
Just clean it. It's fine. It's good.
Oh, it's a three.
Just
clean.
Yeah,
just leave it. It's good.
Hold there.
Good.
Hold
nice shot.
Save a little of that sweeper energy. Well, they're gonna need it later in the game.
Might need it. 1 point game, national championship, men's U sports. Stenke really takes his role at Vice Skip very seriously, says he feels he's the link between the front end and the skip. His job to communicate between those two.
Absolutely. It's without question the most valuable position in the four-man team. A good communicator is an important trait to have.
There.
Same weight.
Oh, hair less.
Line's good, guys.
Hair less.
Oh, this one. Line will be good.
Running a bit more.
Still there.
Line's good. Stay close.
They're still all there.
Oh.
A little bit tight.
That's good.
Good.
Wesman continue to press and try and set up that steal. Yellow stones with that this final shot for the third.
I think it'll be a little bit of curl.
Control, like how's that work?
I think that's close. If it's really curling, I'll try and go like that. But
just yeah, me, yeah.
I think that's good for Ace. I like that.
One more. Get rid of that red and leave
like
himself
that.
Sitting.
This still looks tight to try to make a roll.
I don't know. What did we? You played one kind of in this spot before, didn't you?
I've only been playing this one. I think
or
this is
yeah.
Straighter.
I don't think it's that tight. I don't know.
Okay.
Can hear JT acknowledging that we haven't played
like
that much on that side of the sheet.
Three quarters.
Yeah.
Continues
yeah.
to be an issue.
Even a half with control.
Yeah, I think that's good ice, JT. Just control.
Close.
Soft.
Yep. Yep.
Soft.
Yep.
Like really soft.
Whoa. Whoa then. Whoa.
Try and nose it and push this over.
Yep.
Okay. Just like bump away.
The Wesman line two.
So you heard Rob say it was soft. Look at it over curled.
Touch mark.
Grab it.
Now he sets up this another double possibility and another opportunity for Alberta to blank the lead. Keep control of that hand.
Yeah, Carson.
No hesitation here from Karsten Sturmay. Still at 93% for the 21-year-old from Leduc, Alberta.
Hop, 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 hop,
here at home.
No, 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 no.
Calls off his sweepers. Doesn't get the two.
A little bit of an error there.
One a few. So far from Sturmay.
I think so.
And he acknowledged himself, said just a bad release. Exactly what it was.
To go here.
Give him a free crack at the double.
Want to call timeout and talk about it?
Yeah.
Timeout.
Hey, they're over.
Sturmay looking for the double. New. From the start.
Big point if we can steal.
Well, I mean, timeout, Winnipeg. Barry, like, I don't. Do you think we're stealing anyways? I don't think we're stealing.
Not the best deal.
And even if we're here, it's still the force, right? Because he makes a double, he's still sticking to
shooting. I don't hate that.
It's either that or this, but this may be a, no one's thrown over this way. It's a guess.
Yeah. We've played lots in this spot, hey?
Yeah. What do you think, Gary? Yeah.
I like it, yeah, I like
it. Yeah.
If you're here, he's
not bad. Like, it's a big point if we can steal.
I know, that's what I think. Let's go for the steal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you guys think the steal's over here and let him play the peel and it's not over here? You think he's making that
I think
drive?
So.
I like it then. How you
if you're back here, he's drawing. Even if you're T line, he's got to make the double, right?
Yeah.
He's not rolling out for the blank, so it's still going to be a force.
Yeah. Yeah. So where do you want to put it? Just like right here?
I think, I think back, back forward.
I think you want to make that as, I think our best chance is to have him drive. He's not
to draw.
No, to have him like drive it by. Like I don't want to put it here because he's not gonna
finish. No, no, I'm just saying if it's here, it's still not a blank.
No, probably not. No.
I'm not saying that's where we should go, but I think like we have this much room for error.
Yeah. All right. Okay. I threw those draws. I threw that one draw, and we're like here.
Yeah. And you got, it was a little more than that. I gave you like there.
But that was with a tap too.
Yeah, I think that's close.
I would hate to see a pinch less.
Yeah, almost edge GT.
Yeah, weight's pretty well the same, eh?
Yeah, like anywhere back here, it's fine.
Well, very few words from Coach Jerry Sandy there on the Wesman going for
almost
the steal.
That draw that I think threw in six on that first
the
one, eh?
Thing that he took off the table really quickly was drawing to the other side.
Yeah.
Exactly. And that was another possibility. Then you force Karsten to say, is he going to hit or is he going to draw against two? Now he's putting up the risk of, do I set up a double, which then would allow him to blank the end again? Or am I going to force him to draw down anyhow? So
only if
good strategic discussion.
Mine's good. It's going to be a
result. He's got to make a great shot, though, right?
Let's go away.
It's going to start.
Hard line. Hard line.
Hard line!
Hard line!
Hard!
Come on, where are you?
Another big sweep from the front end.
Where? Top. Okay, I don't want to set up a gimme double. Okay.
Ryan Light.
Alright. I didn't think it was going just on sideways.
That was what we were playing, mate.
And that was the risk. He doesn't put it right there. He sets up that double with it.
We roll out, we roll out.
He needed to be back for it.
Trying to make it up.
Sturmay hasn't missed much and certainly hasn't missed twice in a row. Does the Golden Bears skip respond? Final stone, eighth end, looking for a plank. Doesn't roll away enough, stays in the 12-foot ring. Hammer back to the Wesman. It is one for Alberta, 5-3. Wesman didn't get the steal, but that's the next best result.
Next best result for Winnipeg.
Thank you. down by two.
See how this game is going on there. It's much more difficult to be able to generate those twos than we did in these first couple of games.
It is. How do the Wesmen approach this now? Ninth end, down by two.
I'm sure we're going to see some rocks in play, a couple corners, maybe put a couple of corners up. One in behind each other, or maybe a better strategy given the curl that's there.
Great crowd on hand at the Leduc Recreation Center, watching two University of Alberta teams in the U Sports Championship. And both teams from Alberta leading.
Yeah, that's for you guys.
5-3 here, but now the Wesmen have the hammer. Pandas, the women's team, up 4-3 on the Thompson Rivers Wolfpack.
Close, heavy.
That one heading into the ninth.
It's good. Top eight. Top 12, top eight. Coming down.
Hard boys, my red. Yeah,
he says
it's pretty close.
Oh, boy. As I say,
yeah.
You take a look at Chris Kennedy and his percentages today. He has set up just about every positive outcome for Alberta.
Should be good. Line's good. Tie in. Yep. Okay, you're good, you're good. Take a look.
Mine's good.
Take a look. Never Kyle, never Kyle.
Still off to think advantage. Golden Bears, though, even with a deuce.
Nice shot.
In this ninth, it would be coming home in the 10th, tied with the hammer. Unless the Wesmen are able to take advantage. A couple of misses from Alberta in that last eighth end, and I haven't seen that all game.
No, not at all.
I'm going to be
really interested to see where Winnipeg goes with this guy. They'll be throwing it on the other side. Probably have to, because that one guard on it is not as tight as it could have been.
Full top 12. Might be top 4.
Oh, no, no, no.
Yeah, we're all there.
Another great shot.
The corner.
Or do you like around?
I like around. You guys like around, right? Yep. Try and get it back. House is good. Yeah. It's good. Should be close.
Yep.
Line's good.
Line's good.
Line's really good.
Line.
All you guys make it good. Got a curl. Kyle it. Kyle it. Got a curl, Kyle. Got a curl.
Line's getting real
yeah,
good.
Keep working it. Line's getting good now, buddy. Keep going.
Hard, Kyle.
Keep going, Kyle. Keep going.
Gotta go, Kyle.
Close stop, buddy. Keep going. Hard. Keep going. Good.
Good shot.
Good shot. For sure, right around that board.
Hard, Kyle.
Keep going, Kyle. Keep going.
Gotta go, Kyle.
Close stop, buddy. Keep going. Hard. Keep going. Good.
Good shot.
Hard!
Sweep.
Hard!
I'm going to bring this across.
Good sweep.
Little error. A little tight.
Jason Gittner. The second for the U of A Golden Bears.
Yeah.
I think.
I like that. Yeah.
How's this look? We haven't played anything this way.
That should be close. Make sure you're
to yeah, you have to be positive more. With it, all right?
Maybe a bit can't soft it. Yeah, we can be wide open, it's okay.
Yeah.
Let's go, buddy.
78% for the 24-year-old Winnipeg native.
I think it's okay,
should
yeah.
be okay,
yeah.
normal. I wouldn't say it's okay.
A little more time.
He's also got that old broom.
And you watch him up close too, you just see his leg, his trailing leg actually doesn't touch the ground.
So
heart!
There must be tremendous strength.
Heart!
To be able to do that.
Keep going.
One of the rocks. all the rings.
Shut down.
Oh, good job.
Yeah.
Just enough to get around the red guard. Bites the 12-foot ring now.
Medium.
Medium, guys.
Yeah, you got it.
Medium, Tristan.
There you go.
Well,
three, whoa.
Medium up.
Clean.
Medium up.
Whoa.
No.
Clean.
That's good.
Clean. Again.
Out of there. Great shot, Jay.
8-6.
You either want to roll out or not.
Yeah, just heavy.
A little debate in JT's head about how he's going to be able to use this.
It's not bad.
Control.
Wait, I think you got to throw harder
just
than that to make
the
double. I don't think we're playing the double. We're just playing hit and roll.
Just, what do you like?
Okay, do you like this? I'm still going to make two doubles.
I would like double.
I'd like to make a double.
Go talk to him. Go talk to him.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah, it's not bad.
It's
the double, I might not try that double at this point. I think if leaving those red rocks and playing
like
off, can advantage
what are we playing
him
right now? Just hit and roll
be
there.
Able to score that's
what
that too?
I, that's what I set up
and
for.
Then they just
then they're
it
picking it through the hole, then we make the roll there.
Yeah.
We can make this. They're going to know.
Yeah, and I'm still have to make a double. I don't mind trying this. We don't have that much time, but it's not bad.
Like,
mind you, that's kind of
he's got to play one
yeah,
of those
I
two
don't,
top
I can
red
make
rocks.
This.
Okay.
If you hit it bad, as long as you're in place.
Okay.
So like a thick half and a three quarters, it's fine.
Yeah. Let's roll over.
Thick half.
You get
thick half
hit that,
makes that
roll
like
over by that
side.
Rail.
Kind of wait.
Yeah.
Heel.
But if you hit it thick, it's fine.
How's this
thick
look?
Half. Yeah, thick half. Yeah.
Wesman
yeah
also concerned about
good
the time.
Yeah.
They've
yeah
used almost
injury
5 more minutes than their counterparts from the University of Alberta. Just over 6 minutes to
oh,
go.
Heel, is that what you're like? Oh,
heel.
Oh,
oh, whoa. Heel weight.
No.
Whoa. Heel weight. You got lots of weight.
Curl.
Good.
Good shot, Ty.
And takes out two red.
Who knows?
Whoa. Heel weight.
No.
Whoa. Heel weight. You got lots of weight.
Curl.
Good.
Could have gone a couple of ways there, Perry.
Yeah. The result was good. Again, I think if you would have left those two red, left two red rocks around, it might have been an easier chance for him to get two. There's going to be lots of doubles going here, and it may not end up with him
yes
being able to
yes
score two.
Whoa, whoa,
whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay.
That's pretty good, man.
You have one final score to tell you about. The first Canadian championship has been decided, and that's Douglas College in their first time the Canadian College Championship in 30 years.
Mine came up here a couple
7-3 winners over Fanshawe.
How's this look? Do you want a little left?
I think that's
Douglas
good.
Douglas College
good
Royals, the college Canadian men's champions.
Good for Sterling, another championship.
Sterling Middleton. Quite the resume so far, and now adds
yep
another
oh
trophy to the case.
Oh. Close.
Yeah.
Oh. Yes. Yes.
See, now he's hoping yes for the hit and roll over on top.
Hard.
Hard.
Hard to it.
Trying to get the roll on top. Small tap.
Good job, buddy.
You're just getting it rolling, T8, bud.
Okay.
Medium.
Hard. Hard!
Hard
to it!
Keep making those doubles harder.
Spin up. Nice shot. Good shot, buddy. Yeah.
Still a two possibility for Winnipeg here with that yellow rock they have sitting on the 12th.
Touch bag, eh?
Oh.
Medium up!
Stanky.
Medium!
Hard!
Really hard.
Hard, boys!
Hard!
Last rock for him, asking for a tough sweep. Enough to take up the Winnipeg rock. Leaves two red.
Bit of an error there. Roll inside. Would have liked to seen some roll on that.
No hesitation here for Deering, the third for the Winnipeg Wesmen.
Pulse. Oh, it's good. Oh.
Normal. Firm normal.
Oh, no.
He doesn't like it.
Oh.
Rolls away.
Oh, boy. Okay. All right. That was close to it.
Unfortunate.
And there goes the chance at two, likely.
Well, now it's going to be a fight.
Yeah, I was going to say, do you like your hair more?
No, I gave you mid-four.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Again, another one where just set it out a little bit. A little extra weight, just run straight.
Karsten Sturmay down at 86%.
Line's good.
After a couple of misses
in the eight. Top 12, three, boys. Top 12, three.
Right here, guys. Little room.
But it's pretty good.
Jay tight on this one.
Jay, if you can.
Copy. I can't really.
Like some finish, Jay. Yeah, go
just,
Jay.
Yeah, just almost
even. Even. Even.
Yep.
Good shot.
Pretty good, Karsten. Good shot.
Tough double.
Is there a chance here?
Control? Yeah, I think so.
That should come up, eh?
Yeah. Control over there and you'll have a double.
Maybe still a chance here at two.
If he gets a good roll over there.
JT Ryan
just
now.
Just control, just hit and roll. How's this? We haven't really played any hits this week.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what it's going to do, but
yeah,
it's probably pretty close.
I think this is, yeah.
Be a bit bigger control than you were a couple ends ago.
Yeah.
A bit
doubt here for the Wesmen.
Well, they're talking about exactly what I was thinking. They haven't played a lot of hits in this direction, and they're not sure how much this is going to curl.
That's good. Control.
Oh, yep.
See, they're on it right away.
Hard, guys. Hard.
Need to keep this straight
really
to try and
hard.
Get the roll.
Really hard. Whoa.
See how much that girl, that weight.
Instead, Rex on the guard.
He's got no double hit.
And now Alberta really in charge.
Certainly. Put a good rock in the top of the four, or the 8 foot.
It's almost an automatic force.
Yeah, I'll bite eight.
And with him having to draw to a very small area.
Yeah, just make the adjustment off the last one. Should be same speed.
Sturmay with his last.
Wait, close.
Just glide it.
It's a little tight. Down. Line's good. Tight.
Top 12.
Line's really good.
Just want to bite you. Just want to bite you.
Line's good. Just want to bite the 8 foot.
Line's good.
Just bite the 8 foot. I don't think we got to go. I don't think we got to go.
Just bite the 8 foot.
Whoa. It's right here. Yeah, there.
Sit.
Hold it out.
Really good.
Bites the 8 foot just like they'd hoped for.
See the little fist bump from Karsten. Yeah, put that in the right spot.
He knows it. Knows his team is closing in on a chance to be University Canadian champions.
This is no easy draw against
three. 15-1, so it's pretty quick, yeah.
Pressure shot here for Ryan. Final stone in the ninth.
Little light.
Okay, our Ben. Line good. All you guys.
Line's all yours. Perfect. T.
Line's perfect. Gotta be T line. Line's dead perfect. All you. 14-9. Take a look. Take a look.
Wesman need the draw.
Sit down. Sit down, honey.
Where will this finish? JT Ryan, cool under pressure, needed a force, and he got it.
Good call by the front end on the release. They said, a little light.
Now the Wesmen have to hope to set up a steal down one. 5-4. Another look here at the sweepers.
Sit down. Sit down, honey. Sit down, honey.
Got
it, JP. Boy.
It works good sometimes to get to talk to the rock. Good shot.
One-point game heading into the final end. Alberta has the hammer. And has a chance to put this out of reach. And Perry looking back to how this game started. Boy, it was a different game early on with deuces in the first two ends.
Yeah, and I didn't think that was going to last. You know, a little wide open in those first two ends, creating those deuces. But how it's played out for the back half of the game, it's the respect of these two really good shooting teams. A lot of great shots to get them, and the fact that they're only scoring single points.
Oh, no, that's almost
the end.
This last end could be interesting if we get the guards up.
Curl.
He's got to sit. Catch the curl.
Ben.
JT Ryan, the skip for the Wesmen, has been terrific. This one can't afford to slip in.
Holy.
Pressure cooker there.
Robert.
For the lead, Rod Gordon.
Wiping off the brow.
Like same weight or a little less. Okay, just
yeah, I'll give you a six soft hack.
What? Where do you want for weight?
Like, easy hack?
Yeah,
to close the thought on JT Ryan, 81% has had a couple of misses, but boy, when he has had to be good, Perry, he's been on, and that was a game-saving draw.
It's light.
For sure.
Quick light.
Here's the ticket.
Attaboy, Kennedy.
Executed perfectly by Chris Kennedy. 96% the lead for the Alberta Golden Bears. Top curler today.
The judges.
Good to split those apart.
Need more. I think that's good, Kyle.
Yeah, that's halfway.
Yeah, that's good.
Mine's
the
good.
Guy said the
Mine's
weight
good.
Was a bit
easy,
down.
Easy. Take a look.
Halfway.
Yeah. We'll see how this end builds at the end, but those two rocks sitting in those positions where they are right now could block off one of the paths to the button. If Karsten's forced to be able to do that.
Roll to an edger. If you roll too far, that's a miss.
Okay.
Medium.
Okay. Medium.
Good medium. Here you go. Okay. Medium.
Yep. Hard.
Medium.
Yes. Hard. Hard. Stay on it. Hard. Rolling this thing.
Great shot.
Really good.
Good shot.
Medium.
Yes. Hard. Hard. Stay on it. Hard. Rolling this thing.
Chris has had an outstanding game.
Make it good.
Make it good. Yeah. Yeah. Make this one good. And then
the line's good.
Yeah.
Nice and quicker.
Yeah.
In the Women's U Sports Championship, the Alberta Pandas with a deuce in the ninth now have a 6-3 lead.
Real,
so
hard early.
The Golden Bears are able to hang on. It could be a sweep.
Just top 12.
Championship.
Top 8.
happened back in 2015 when the U of A won both the men's and the women's.
We're high.
Looking to repeat at home 3 years later.
Easy, let's sit. Let's sit.
Sit. No, 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 foul. No.
Okay, that's fine.
It's a good spot. Good.
Okay. Yeah.
Interesting. Nobody trying for a high guard, like a one guard. Keep two guards in play.
Ginter at 91%. This Alberta team has been locked in all day.
Nice shot, dude.
Certainly the front end for the Golden Bears has been terrific, Perry.
Couldn't have asked for better, a 96 and a 91. And those shots that they just made is only going to get better.
Sink it on his last. Yeah, you bet.
It's a little cool. Less.
Yeah, you got it, T. Yeah, touch less.
Makes the game much easier for the back end when they play like that.
Nice. Halfway.
Our line's tight early.
1 point lead in the final end.
Not bad.
That'll be close. We're good for weight.
We're good.
Never,
good.
Don't need to throw, guys.
Halfway. Halfway tight.
Whoa.
Halfway.
Tight, no room for error tight. Now yeah, for really the going. Winnipeg Wesmen.
Really,
let it sit and curl.
Yeah, let's go ahead and sit.
Sit.
Sit, honey.
Good shot, Ty.
Good. Good. Yeah, good shot. That's good.
Yeah, keep going by then.
Yeah.
There you go.
Don't walk.
There you go, Jay.
Don't need to be a bit higher.
Trying to get two.
Risk and reward. Gonna curl up a bit more.
Had a big chance there too.
Speed's good.
Put the Wesmen in real trouble. In the men's college championships, Camos and Chargers stole one in the 10th to even things up. That one off to an extra end. Winnipeg hoping to do the same.
Halfway.
Line only.
How
tight.
Much? Line's good.
Line on.
Line's nice.
It's about as tight as tight.
How tight?
If not tighter.
It's got to really. Whoa.
Tighter?
It's pretty close too, yeah.
No, try it. It, leave it.
No, no, no.
Right.
Sit. It's trying.
Should be okay.
Yeah. Sit.
It's got to sit.
Shot. Good. Yeah, good shot.
All right.
Good shot. It's good. What's wrong with that?
Boy, he has to see the
shot. Yeah. Well, obvious point. Similar shot.
Take 5 feet off it.
Yeah, just a little bit off of it. Better way, halfway.
Needs a bit more room.
A little bit more room.
Let's get
it.
Bring it over there, T.
Just at the end, T. Yeah, keep going
now.
Hard, T.
Hard, buddy, go.
Hard.
Keep going, both people. Both people. You gotta keep going, it's really dying. Keep going.
Go.
Keep going.
Go.
Hard.
That's good.
That's good.
Good shot. Time out here, called by the U of A. Coach Rob Krepps, come out for a chat. Let's take a listen.
Either the top one or it's right on the beat.
I was looking at those, yeah. Well, you could, I can make this, but
well, yeah, it's either you take a crack at that.
That's
or
a really
right
good leave as well.
So, the top one, or it's right on the beat. So, the thing about nosing this is that
he's got to make something real good for you not to be able to connect with that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's Tristan's last one here, right?
Yeah.
That's not a very good guard.
Time could be an issue for the Wesmen.
To move that either, though, because it's kind of in no man's land.
Down at 211.
Well, the thing is that what they're going to do if we just keep ripping, right, is that they're going to go around that rock.
And it's a short run.
I guess it's just what's my margin with the hit? Like, if I think I would be wanting to roll away, if anything. Like, rolling underneath really isn't very good at all. Right?
Even if he knows, though, it's still kind of two guards for them.
Noses.
My gut says you try to slam that in there. Yeah, if you're going past.
They still got to make something really good to get underneath.
Yeah, okay.
You know? Yeah. Let's just make this.
Let's give it a good honest straddle.
That big cheer going up across on Sheet E, the University of Alberta Pandas, heading on to the international stage, and they are the women's U Sports champions.
7-8.
A double from Kristen Streifel.
Dead center.
6-3 the final over Thompson Rivers.
That's good.
You got it, buddy.
And the man complete the sweep.
Well, a good discussion around the strategy of what to do, and I like this call. He wants to take one more crack at trying to run these two.
Yep. Hard. Whoa.
No.
Okay.
No.
Oh. Almost, buddy. Good throw.
Trying to get that double instead. Slides past.
Real close.
Wesman's still alive. Into Skip Stones now. How does Winnipeg try and get this steal?
Make this one good, hey?
Yep.
Good center guard here.
Certainly he's going to put a guard up here, I think. And then have him take it off. Probably then come around the back of that, his own yellow. And then hope that Karsten nuts it. Essentially runs it back and leaves him sitting there.
It's nice.
Line's good, guys.
Line only.
Line's good.
Line's fine.
Tighter
than yours, Kyle.
Oh, easy
all
then.
All there. Halfway.
Clean
halfway.
If you can.
Clean it. It's got to curl a little bit.
Don't want to take it too tight.
Okay, where are you?
We're halfway to this dot. Okay.
Yep. Keep going. Go. Right over time.
Good. Nice shot. Well done, buddy.
I'm just wondering, I guess you're always rolling it off.
Definitely that.
Okay.
So we'll be fifth time lucky. I think we've had four cracks at this, right?
Okay, let's make it, boys.
Yeah.
Another chance here for the U of A. First of two for Sturmay. At 88%. He's been to the University Championship in Canada twice, but the third time looking for that elusive gold medal.
Oh!
Is the double there?
Nope.
That's all good.
Wesman down to 1:35 on the clock.
That there,
Jerry Sandy out for another chat.
Take enough time, I guess.
I think I'm using it for time.
I agree. I was just asking. We've played the draw so many times.
Yeah.
Let's make it.
Take enough, right?
I think so.
You're right, Terry. Quick chat.
Manage that clock. Give JT the time down the hack to make a good shot.
The way that my other ones have been busting, even that guard came over.
Yeah.
Make him throw it.
And take a look where the
all right, JT, let's go,
the rowdy's taking
four.
down the side. They know.
Same way, even throwing for that draw coming this way. I think it's pretty similar speed, hey?
Yeah.
You got this one in your back pocket here, buddy. Let's go. Let's make it.
Inch less.
Well,
last rock here for Ryan.
Can we? Where?
And he doesn't really, like
it's
it.
It's all there. We got to come off that. We got to come off that.
It's still over curled. He knows it.
Well, it's yeah, like then. Through.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, if you can.
We got
it. He's not even looking at the rock.
Okay, good game, guys. Good game, Tristan.
And it is out the back. Could you script it any better? An Alberta sweep at home. The Golden Bears are the men's U Sports champions.
Yeah.
Three times lucky.
Boy.
It's off to the 2019 winner, Universiad in Russia. And for Karsten Sturmay.
Yes, Chris.
And there's the brother-sister duo, national champions Selena and Karsten, both to wear the maple leaf. And for Sturmay, a two-time silver medalist at this very championship. Third time's a charm, and now he's golden.
Well, what a great game by Alberta. You know, led by their lead and their second, the percentages that those young men put up today. Just an outstanding effort.
And what a moment for this University of Alberta program. They swept 3 years ago back in 2015, and they do it again. Canadian curling dominance.
Well deserved.
Six to four is the final for the University of Alberta Golden Bears. And we're hoping to get down to ringside again to talk to the winning skip, Karsten Sturmay, who was terrific all game long. His front end set him up beautifully, finishing at 88%. A couple of misses in the back half, but he certainly was great all the way to the end, Terry.
Well, I think that the front end play is what set it up. There was never really a moment where Winnipeg put them at risk. And that just speaks to the strong front end play that they had. A really talented team, and they will represent as well.
And with the University of Alberta Pandas winning 6-3. Pass me that script, Terry. Could you write it any better?
Not if you're a fan of Alberta, which there's lots of them in the stands. But I mean, Leduc has put on an outstanding event. Curling Canada is to certainly be commended by this format, what they've created for our athletes. A wonderful moment. And I know these young men and women will do very well when they get to Russia. They'll be used to those conditions, given what they've had this week.
A lot of green and gold in the stands.
But good marks to the Wesmen.
Yep.
They played well. They got to this final and put out an outstanding effort. Few half shots, you know.
One game still going on. It's the Women's College Championship. That's in an extra end. Two rocks to go for Fanshawe College. Certainly an excellent program. They've won five titles at the college national level since 2012. The Falcons looking to make it six.
against the Camosun Chargers.
Tough shot coming up for them, though. Just got to run that straight back.
Will have a chance to go down ringside to Karsten Sturmay. He is standing by in just a moment. Him and his sister Selena off to the world stage. First though, Terry, it's the mixed doubles, already Canadian champions. Now time to start all over again. First draw tonight, that goes six local time, eight Eastern.
No rest for these guys.
No time to celebrate.
I'm not sure whether when their draw time is, but they're going to miss the banquet tonight and all the the recognition.
I have to make sure we put a plate aside.
Well, they're going to get their recognition in a minute here. The medals are wonderful that they're going to be presented, and those big, beautiful banners that sit there in the back. They're going to hang nicely in the rafters at the Saville Center.
Third time for this University of Alberta men's program winning the Canadian University Championship. That's the most of any on the men's. For the University of Alberta, the Pandas, that's their third national championship. Only the Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawks have more with four. Certainly, the U of A has emerged as a Canadian curling superpower in the last couple of years and capped off by a sweep at home here in Leduc.
Like we're close to getting Karsten.
And when he will have a special guest along with him. Sister Selena, also a Canadian champion. About 5 minutes earlier.
Down to the last shot in the college women's game.
Last rock in the extra end. That's a great point, Terry. Fanshawe College out of London, Ontario.
Coach Wesman going out and having a conversation about, well, do I draw or do I try and do that double? It's actually just pretty much the same shot that Karsten took five attempts at.
All right, we're ready to go down ringside now. A brother and sister duo, Karsten and Selena Sturmay. Congratulations to you both. Karsten, let's start with you. A terrific finish. You were excellent all game long. What did it take to keep you and your team calm down the stretch when you had the hammer?
You know what? I really think we just focused on the process out there. It would have been really easy to get caught up in the outcomes of what ifs and maybes, but we just stuck to our routines and really threw them to make them out there.
All right, and Selena, I want to ask you, Karsten, you might have to help us out with this question, but Selena, also a Canadian championship. What does it mean to both of you sweep here at home?
What does it mean to you to sweep the championship here at home?
It's obviously an amazing feeling. Going into it, we knew that it was our last game, and we just wanted to leave everything on the line. Regardless of the outcome, we just wanted to play our best. And yeah, it was great that we won.
So not only an Alberta sweep, but also a brother-sister sweep for you as well. And Karsten, I'm sure that makes it extra special.
Oh, it's extremely special. It was a longtime dream of ours to both compete at a national championship together, and we've had the good fortune to do that here and at juniors, and it's going to be a crazy feeling getting to wear the maple leaf with my little sister.
Getting a great shot of you after you're both Canadian champions. Karsten, let's go back to your history at the university level. Two times a silver medalist in this very championship. Three times a charm, as they say. It's certainly the case for you. How good does this feel now to be a Canadian university champion?
Oh, it feels unreal. Like, I'm just so proud of my team for the amount of work that they've put in over the past couple of years. And we've been really close and had a lot of success, but always just seem to come up that one game short. So to finally cap it off here is, words can't even describe how happy I am right now.
Karsten, I want you to ask Selena, you are both competing in the Mixed Doubles Canadian Championships together. That starts tonight. You have no chance to try and save this victory. How will it be going from university champions now into another Canadian championship?
How do you feel about competing in the Canadian Mixed Doubles Championship after this together?
I honestly just think it's such an honor to represent Alberta any chance that you have. Obviously, moving forward, it's great that we won, but we're going to put our best foot forward and try and win our second national championship.
Certainly a great moment for both of you. Congratulations, and we're looking forward to seeing you in the mixed doubles.
Thank you
so much.
Karsten and Selena Sturmay, an Alberta sweep. It's a brother-sister sweep, too. The University of Alberta, the Pandas and the Golden Bears, U Sports champions at home in Leduc. And what a way to finish. And stay with us here on cbcsports.ca. We will have the medal presentations for both the Golden Bears and the Pandas. And finally, the last game, the College Women's Championship, wrapping up in an extra end. And Terry, during the interview, you had a great chance to watch that last rock.
Well, a big decision by Fanshawe whether to try that same sort of run double that that we saw Karsten in Alberta try to make. But there was just about a third of a rock of the one sitting in the house, and the Fanshawe skip was able to pick it out and had a nice one counter on the other side, so a single point, and they are women's champions.
There you have it, the Fanshawe Falcons, Canadian College Women's Champion. And what a program that has been at the college level in Canada. Now six championships for the men and the women since everything started again in 2012. And not too far from where you're located at Ryerson, London, Ontario, a short drive away, certainly an excellent program.
Yeah, they have an excellent program there. Led by Coach Wesman, and I've had the pleasure of coaching some of the male athletes on the male team, so the men's team. So I'm a little disappointed for them, but 2 years in a row, they've made it into the final, and they a couple of those boys leave the program this year, so they'll go on to their men's career, and hopefully they have as much success in their men's career.
Was going to ask you about Douglas College as well. Certainly one of the favorites coming in. Not often you see a favorite in the first year of the program for a long, long time, but student-driven Douglas College. They had a couple athletes that wanted to be here, and they made it happen, and now they're Canadian College men's champions.
Well, it's a similar story to our story at Ryerson. We had a couple of athletes come into their first year at the university. We didn't have a program in place. We're able to kind of put things together, and when you have talented athletes who want to curl and they want to curl at this level, it's good news when you get the support of the college or the university, and proud for them. Don't know much about them because they're way out there on the West Coast, but certainly know the quality of the athletes that they have, so that's when it all comes together.
Has to be a nice moment for Sterling Middleton, a two-time Canadian junior champion and a recent gold medalist while playing at the World Youth Olympics. Quite the resume for him so far. As The third for Douglas College, a big part in helping his team take the college men's championship. Be sure to stay with us, of course, the medal ceremony coming up. Four championships across the board. It's been a terrific 5 days in Leduc. And now it's only getting started with the mixed doubles and the wheelchair Canadian championships going on right now.
Yeah, the wheelchairs are a few draws in. Yep. I was over and talking to the Ontario team. Some of them I know curl at the same club that my wife's program goes out of. Had a tough first game, but bounced back in their second. Seemed to have a sense of, you know, where the ice was then for them. This is a great facility for not only what we've done for the college and university teams, but for the wheelchair teams. Completely accessible facility, great 8-sheet environment, easy for them to get around in this facility. My hat's off to Danny Lamoureux and Curling Canada for what they've done in putting this together, and of course all the organizers here in Leduc. Couldn't have run a better show. As I was talking to Danny after I got off the mixed doubles practice ice and said, great effort, looked like it ran like clockwork, and if it didn't, it didn't show.
You would never know. A lot of work putting together four Canadian championships in the span of 10 days. Certainly the facility has been great, and it's a lot of organization as well, like you just said.
Well, the ice making team too, turning the ice over in the time that it is to keep us all on track. And hats off to the officials. They spent four draws a day out here in a hockey rink. On the ice,
it's chilly.
It's chilly.
You're down there as a coach. Certainly our hardworking crew knows it as well. It's a chilly spot to be.
Yeah, the people in the stands are enjoying the heaters above.
Yeah.
and feeling a little more comfortable that way. But for those of us who were sitting on the ice, at least they gave us risers. That was a good thing. We were saying that if the risers weren't there, it might have been just a little bit colder.
Couple of bronze medal games to talk to you about as well. Two in the 10th for the University of New Brunswick Varsity Reds. That's on the men's side, so over the Waterloo Warriors. Bronze for UNB. Happy for them to step on the podium, that's for sure. And we knew about this one for a long time, but the Brock Badgers on the women's side taking care of the Mounties. 12-2, that one done after six.
Well, again, congratulations to the Brock team, and Coach Murray and Coach Karen and their program. They put a lot of effort into that. And to the four ladies there, one of which curls competitively with my daughter. And I took them this year to the Ontario Scotties. So they're a good group of women, and they have good careers ahead of them. I also have to commend you at the CBC for bringing university and college curling to the masses. We appreciate that.
The first time.
Yeah, we really appreciate
it. It's been a pleasure
that.
Covering it so far, that's for sure.
And you've probably now had a chance to get a perspective of the quality of play, too.
Certainly, it's been great over the last 5 days. And it's great to see that there's a smooth transition now between a lot of successful junior players. They're opting to play in university and college, and then hoping either to go into a professional career with an education or pursue a career on tour.
Absolutely. And, you know Brandon and Kelsey are prime examples of that from Alberta and the success that they've had. Hopefully we see a few more from other regions of the country.
Ladies and gentlemen, did you enjoy the round of curling this afternoon?
We'll be ready to go down to the medal presentation in just a moment.
We're going to start with the University men's bronze medal to the New Brunswick Varsity Reds.
You got to come over.
They're a shy bunch. Here they come, the UNB Varsity Reds bronze medalist.
Second, Evan McKnight. Third, Trevor Kroos. Skip, Jack Schmelzer. New Brunswick Varsity Reds. University men's silver medal. Their coach, Jerry San. Lead, Rob Gordon. Second is Ty Dalio. Third, Kyle Doring. And their skip, JT Ryan. Silver medal, Winnipeg Wesmen. University medal, or University men's gold medal, the Alberta Golden Bears. Coach Rob Krepps. Alternate Glenn Benance. Lead Chris Kennedy. Second Jason Ginter. Third Tristan Stanky. And their skip Karsten Sturmay. Alberta Golden Bears. Next, we'll have the college women. Bronze medal goes to Nate Ooks. Their coach, Jules Auchard. Alternate, Nicole Sawyak. Lead, Rachel Clark. Second, Dana Algott. Third, Karina Sartor Pilak. Skip Emily Clark. The Nate Ooks. Silver medal, Campbell Sun Chargers. Their coach, Melissa Soligo. Lead, Sydney Brills. Second, Mariah Columb. Third, Jordan Coster. And a skip, Taylor Reese Hansen. Camosun Chargers. College women gold medal. Vanshaw Falcons. Coach Barry Wesman. Alternate Angelica Buscadere. Lead Isabel Allen. Second Samantha Lees. Third Aaron White. And their skip, Caitlin Poirier. Vanshaw Falcons. Next are university women, bronze winners. Brock University Badgers. Their coach, Murray Etherington. Alternate, Jeanette Burnside. Lead, Joanna Frank Colini. Second, Marcia Richardson. Third, Jessica Humphreys. Skip, Terry Weeks. Brock University Badgers. University Women's Silver Medal. Thompson Rivers Wolfpack. Their coach, Allison McInnes. Lead, Samantha Fisher. Second, Desiree Hawes. Third, Aaron Pincott. And their skip, Corin Brown. Thompson Rivers Wolfpack. University Women Gold Medal. University of Alberta Pandas. Their coach, Garry Coderre. Alternate, Paige Papley. Lead, Jesse Isles. Second, Selena Sturmay. Third, Danielle Scheimeneman. Sorry. And their skip, Kristen Streifel. University of Alberta Pandas. College men, bronze medal. Nate Ooks. Coach Carl Maziak. Alternate, J.J. Crowder. Lead, Sam Stephenson. Second, John Ritchie. Third, Jonah Tobinski. And their skip, Trig Jensen. Nate Ooks. College silver men. Fanshawe Falcons. Winning. Lead, Bradley St. Louis. Second, Tyler Twining. Third, Logan James. And their skip, Charlie Richard. Fanshawe Falcons. College Man Gold Medal, Douglas Royals. Their coach, Will Sutton. Lead, Nicholas Umbach. Second, Braden Carpenter. Third, Sterling Middleton. And their skip, Daniel Winzik. Douglas Royals.
University of Alberta, Golden Bears and the Pandas, a sweep at home for the first time in 3 years. They're off to the Winter University at 2019 in Russia. The Pandas, Paige Papley, Jessica Isles, Selena Sturmay, Danielle Schmiemann, Kristen Streifel, the champions for the women. For myself, Matt Cullen, Terry Marshall, the Alberta men winning as well, 5-4. Lots more curling still to come. The mixed doubles starts tonight. You can join us, 8 o'clock Eastern. See you then.
Great shot.
We gotta hold on
there. We gotta come off that. We gotta come off that.
Yes!
Please welcome U Sports Scott Ring.